ready to board the Harbor Master. Easter Sunday night, 104.7 FM is the official station for Clash of Generations.
More FM, 104.7 and Wire 868 every Thursday at 3 30 p.m. for your sports and review. Weekly sports update, live interviews, opening and close credit, 1 by 30 seconds and 5 minutes. Join us and be in the know.
Or call 789-2881.
Put food on your table. ADC is affordable. Shop at ADC Supermarket Cleaver Road, a very comfortable and clean environment. These prices are unbelievable. Come see for yourself. We have the best alcohol prices. Don't miss out.
Get those specials on liquor.
Put food on your table with ADC Supermarket, conveniently located at number 4 Cleaver Road in Arima. Every Friday and Saturday is real vibes and live entertainment from your very own DJ Christian on Friday and Saturday. Everyone is talking about ADC Supermarket. Shop in comfort and in a clean environment with the best prices for all your grocery needs. A secured parking. Remember, free delivery. Put food on your table. ADC is affordable. ADC Supermarket, number 4 Cleaver Road in Arima.
More music festivals.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
Disclaimer. More FM Limited, its owners and associates, accepts no responsibility for statements made by the talk show hosts or their guests. More FM Limited does not endorse any of the information provided during this commercially booked segment as the truth. That you have to judge for yourself. We, however, reserve the right to question statements made. But in this time of misinformation, government-controlled media, and corruption, it is sometimes hard to get the truth. But we must try. It is not our intention to discriminate or annoy anyone. We believe it is our constitutional right to free speech, to voice our opinion, and our duty to the population and country to expose the truth. More FM Limited takes no responsibility for the opinions of others.
Yes, indeed. A pleasant good morning to all and sundry, East, West, North, South, Central, or President Tobago, and wherever you are streaming on the World Wide Web. A pleasant good day to you. Yes, this is the Thursday edition of the Ground Report, of course, the penultimate day before, of course, the end of the week. Yes, indeed. But, of course, we resume and we continue, of course, on Monday, without a doubt. Of course, during the course of the day, one expects that a number of information, or should I say, new pieces of information will come to the fore. But of course, I await my colleague to, of course, lay the platform or the groundwork before, of course, I engage any further. Having said that, of course, let me indicate to you that, of course, there is, of course, a number of headline issues that are very, very interesting indeed, of course, and it simmers down today. The macabre and the very, what I consider to be violent and virulent situation as far as crime and criminality is concerned. But of course, it still lingers on, the whole question of raid and raiding, and of course the question of those bones that were found, human remains that were found on a Valsain compound, continues, of course, to attract the attention of law enforcement, and of course kind of what I consider to be hideous scenario at the address where those human remains were found, and of course the person who is the main suspect is yet to be found as well. There is a dragnet, of course, APB, all points bulletin, as the police will say, that is out for the main suspect. That being as it may, of course, clarify constitution reform exercise. Yes, of course, there's a call for the clarification. Dr. Rowley said some committee some committee would have been, of course, appointed in order to collate and to act as a clearing house, not that is making any decisions and so on. So the question is being asked, well, who will advise him? One, or the government? And then, of course, we see that unilaterally, I should say, but maybe unanimous from the point of view of the UTAM, of the People's National Movement, talking about they are considering the constitution, and they've made certain recommendations. Well, we too on the ground report will certainly do our part as well, because of course we want to look at in particular the whole question of elections in this country, the role of the EBC, whether that in itself should be revamped to a point where it cannot, or it is insulated totally from political interference or consideration. And then of course you have the whole question of elections in itself, reform, and you also have, of course, the whole question of limited time for prime minister, as well as recall on the agenda. And of course you also have the whole question of recall of parliamentarians in situations where they would have, of course, not conform to what is expected by the constituents of the particular constituency. So all of those things are to be considered, including, of course, the expansion of constituencies. Not that the EBC is inadequate and does not have the mandate so to do, but having regard to its performance, particularly in recent times, and the fact that it is clearly influenced by political, specifically by the PNM, who is prepared, of course, to influence and interact and to proceed with abandoned caution to, of course, interfere, having regard to what we have experienced. So then, from that perspective, there is a need for constitutional reform that will impact on the electoral processes in Trinidad and Tobago. That being as it may, Tobago students win junior, senior folk choirs at a music festival. Congratulations to the Tobago lads, the young ones, who of course have participated in that exercise. A murder accused on bail, granted bail for having a stolen car. Whether or not that is an argument to not provide bail for murder, that is also a constitutional matter as well. The courts have categorically shut down any notion that the murder should be devoid of, or in any way not subjected to the opportunity for bail, a fundamental principle in, of course, our own jurisdiction, our own jurisprudence. And that is to say, a person is innocent until proven guilty. And of course, to curtail one's freedom by not being able to access bail is offensive to, of course, the principle that we have grown accustomed to, and that we have inherited from the Westminster system or the British system of justice administration, and therefore that has been now cleared, and the persons who are murder accused should be given bail under the discretion, of course, as usual, of the courts. No charges yet under hose ban. So no charges yet under hose ban. Well, as you know, WASA has indicated, the Ministry of Public Utilities has indicated that there is, of course, in effect, the non-use of hoses. I think it's $75 now. Gonzalez is saying that that should be upgraded. The same thing would apply to murders and all of the mayhem that is taking place as far as crime and criminality is concerned. So it is a matter of human being recognizing and disciplining themselves, and of course the government providing as a facilitator the conditions where people would feel comfortable to maintain and to adhere and not breach the various, whether it's criminal or civil, principles and or codes that we are subjected to govern this society. So I leave that there. I know that some of you who are more erudite than myself will certainly, of course, choose this topic to address. Postal workers shut up shop to demand salary increases. Well, yes, they have, of course, brought the Salary Review Commission as far as the report by the government and the, not the shelving of it, but the postponing or send it back for review, of course, under some serious recriminations and excoriating comments. But of course, we know this government are very adept as far as theatrics is concerned and histrionics. So they will play that. But of course, it was sent for review and not shelving. But of course, I maintain the position that they will not, of course, engage those particular recommendations, which of course increases the salaries of both the Prime Minister, that of the opposition leader, and other senior members of government in the public sphere. But of course, their major concern was that the judges and other judicial officers were not captured in that particular report, and therefore they have sent it back and say that it was short-sighted, myopic, or incomplete. So we see what will happen there. But I can assure you of this: it will only happen if our PNM returns to office, if Rowley returns to office. In other words, I'm saying that it will not happen before the completion of the elections. But we do not, as we have been saying, we predict and we anticipate that there will be a UNC victory in whatever configuration that it may eventually turn out to be. But certainly the non-return of the PNM is inevitable and is certain as when night give way to day and vice versa, or as constant as the Northern Star and immutable like a scent, cannot change. And that is the PNM cannot continue in office having regard to its performance on the basis of corruption, nepotism, cronyism, and mismanagement of the economy, our resources, and the misappropriation of same. That being as it may, THA monitors health impact on oil spill in Lambo. So of course that oil spill continues to make the news, particularly in our sister isle, and of course internationally as well, having regard of course to the extreme concern about the environment, and in this case the aquatic or the marine environment, where the ecology and other concerns for the use of these resources placed there by the Almighty, or some might say nature, depending on your religious perspective. You know, you have the agnostics and you have of course those persons who don't believe in God at all, and we have to, that's the reality of Trinidad and Tobago and the world, in fact. Griffith SSA asked for a pastor to be SRP. That is something we did not ventilate much yesterday. I trust that it may be it should be a front burner, major front burner issue, let me put it that way, this morning, because of course it's a developing story that requires some attention, having regard to the announcement by the Prime Minister that the National Security Council recommended to the Cabinet. Of course, Rowley has always said that the National Security Council is him, and therefore one can safely say that is he who, of course, recommended to the his own cabinet, recommend to himself, of course, to, generate not just investigations, but certainly respond to what is purported to be a police concern as to some development of a breach of national security. But we have heard that before by Dr. Rowley. He did say that the SUSU money issue was a national security breach. He did say that in such circumstance, he was prepared to, as National Security Council leader, to, of course, engage detectives and all law enforcement agents from Barbados and the UK. So we have seen him take charge in that way on a political platform. We have seen him as well dismiss us ostensibly and practically and all in, for all intents and purposes, a commissioner of police as well. So we know, and then of course initiate an investigation into, of course, the conduct of that commissioner of police. I'm talking here about Gary Griffith, under of course his stewardship and the issuance of license of firearms. Of course, the courts have said already that that was illegal, the conduct of Dr. Rowley, purporting to be, of course, some operational arm of the state in terms of the business of the independent institution called the police service. I say no more. I know that people are more aware and would have been focusing on those matters, but it's just in brief to lay the foundation for the discussion. Autopsy on body found in Venezuela man's throat slit. Well, of course, there is the speculation that it's one of the five, I think, persons that are missing. I'm talking about fishermen, and I don't know if that has been confirmed, but my information so far is that it has not yet been confirmed. But there's a deep suspicion that it's one of those persons who have been categorized as missing, as fishermen from Trinidad. Teen's body found buried at Valsin House of Horror. Well, we mentioned that yesterday. Another Massey executive resigns. I wonder why. There seemed to be this necromancy, this supernatural, focus that has enveloped this particular, what I consider to be, conglomerate. Yes, it is, in for all intents and purposes, since of course it has not only reached in Trinidad but throughout the Caribbean as well, and are looking at, or have been looking, and I think it has some interest in the United States as well. But of course, that is something we will ventilate as far as we can. Gone too soon. Creative community mourns Vanna Gerard. Yes, I didn't read that too much, so I cannot comment briefly on it. No charges yet under whose ban. Those are some. Oh, just one more. Of course, Jack Warner still wants information or info on fees paid by state in extradition. But yeah, I think that is a valid request. That being as it may, of course, we go for the break as per usual. And when we come back, more. Just one more. I'm seeing here. Ferguson seeks an injunction to stop Miami U.S. $131 million judgment recovery. These and more we will discuss when we return. This is the Thursday edition of the Ground Report. See you after the break.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
Chinyan Ari Restaurant is open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. 67 Western Main Road, St. James, opposite Standards. Serving local breakfast items like sada, fry bake, roast bake, and pies. With all your favorite local fillings. Assorted lunches available from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Get pilau for $25 or get combination lunches from $25 to $40. They also have soup specials as well as crab and dumpling from 6 p.m. p.m. Have dinner on the pavement a la carte with burgers, fried nuggets, gyro, and just about anything you can think about. Call 382-9347 to place your order. Shiny and Ari, Main Road, St. James. Open 7 days a week.
The big question today, how much will my electricity bill increase? Stop worrying. Act now. Replace your bulbs with energy-efficient LED bulbs now available at Trinity Lighting. When you purchase 4 60-watt LED bulbs for $112.50, you get 2 absolutely free. That's right, absolutely free. Or purchase 3 100-watt LED bulbs for the same price and get 1 100-watt LED bulb free. Trinity also has the following options. Purchase 2 4-foot LED tubes or 1 8-foot or 2 LED colored bulbs for the same price, $112.50. At Trinity, we also stock specialty items and a wide range of electrical supplies for all your household, medical, marine, commercial, and much more. Any hard to find bulbs or parts, we can source it locally or internationally. Check us out at 123 Western Main Road in St. James or call 628-8373, WhatsApp 461-8620, or email trinityetc@yahoo.com.
Hey, you!
Yes, you!
Need quality printing at affordable prices? Then look no further! At Graphic Source, we've got you covered! Take your project to the next level for all your designs and printing needs! From t-shirt printing to labels, signs, and banners! Look no further! Business stamps, flyers, tickets, and invites, just to name a few! With 2 convenient locations, Eastern Main Road, St. Augustine, opposite Massey's Doors, and Arima Shopping Center, Broadway Street, Arima! Contact us today! 342-2664-270-0428 or 360-8917. Graphic Source, your number one source. You name it, we design it and print it.
Every word. Every line. Every paragraph. Depicts a real moment in someone's life. A father, a sister, a mother, a brother. We at Newsday are dedicated to you, the people, and through independent, unwavering journalism, strive to always bring your stories to life. Because your stories are more than just words. Newsday. Independent and credible.
The rainy season is here, so be weather smart and change your tires to handle the nation's wet roads. After all, you don't want to be the one to cause any accidents, do you? So why not check out Racetrack Wheels right now? They're the only one that gives you quality tires to hold the road properly. And to top it off, Racetrack Wheels carries all sizes of tires for all makes of vehicles. They are the sole distributors for Saylan and Achilles tires. These tires carry a full manufactured warranty and is the number one tire for comfort and performance in this rainy weather. We have the latest rims in all sizes, all at drastically low prices. We also do blank wheels that could be drilled to your vehicle specification. It's all about new technology and keeping ahead of the game.
So hurry on down to Racetrack Wheels, 3 locations. 330 Eastern Main Road, Arouca. 82 Bethany Road, Buco, Tobago. And 64th Southern Main Road, Chase Village. Or call 285-9168.
So my friend, take it from me and be weather smart this season. And change your tires right now at Racetrack Wheels.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
Yes, indeed. We are back. Time check is just about 36 minutes past the hour, 6 o'clock. And, of course, we continue to take your many calls on a daily basis. Let me say that I might have missed one or two things that are dear to me. For example, of course, the Mova Lavender students is say no to crime. I think that was a beautiful gesture on their part. The chief secretary, I've never received kickbacks. He says it's something that's been manufactured and promoted by the PNM. Well, we know that is stereotypical of that particular entity. And of course, cops raid Valsin home, of course, home of horror. And of course, they set up, of course, as I said, road blocks in order to hunt the main suspect. But of course, we need for you to get to the lines immediately. And of course, the numbers to call. Well, of course, these numbers include or continue to be the same, let me put it that way. And to, of course, just to reiterate, 229-0251, 229-0251, and 239-5120. 239-5120. And of course, the other WhatsApp number, the 366-3053, 366-3053. And this morning, well, I'm not going to tell you if you need me. You can get me at, I will not tell you that this morning. If you need me, you will not, you can get me at the 336-6594. That is because I can boast this morning, a Good Samaritan yesterday, of course. Yesterday evening, in fact, I called and said, I have a telephone for you. So it avoids me having to expense myself because I misplaced mine. And I want to thank that person. I would have loved to call his name. I by now you would know is a he. But of course, he said that he prefers to remain anonymous. But however, I cannot. It would be remiss of me if I did not, of course, thank him. He know who he is. But to let you know that, in fact, my phone as well will be up and running at least for tomorrow, because I have to go and do the normal activation, etc., etc. One similar to what I would have had, if not an upgraded one. So I want to thank profusely that individual who just heard my plight and decided, of course, that they would make that contribution. That is what I expect of Trinidad, of Trinbegonians. And therefore, when I asked for Andy to be sent a little note, but also put something in an envelope for him, is along that line, because not only are we self-gratifying, but because you have told us that we are doing such human service, some nationalistic service, such patriotic service. And in fact, the caller, well, that person asked me to mention him as a patriot. So let me use the right word as well. I can't be remissive. So that patriot, I want to thank you. But of course, let's leave something for Andy. He has not asked us to, of course, as I said, advocate for him. But I think it's only fair. Let me repeat those numbers again, just in case no one is yet there. 229-0251, 229-0251 for the new callers. 239-5120, 239-5120. And of course, the WhatsApp number, 3663, notice I did not solicit for any assistance with the phone. I simply said I don't have one and I give an alternative number. This person just volunteered to, of course, support, and I want to appreciate his gesture. Let's go to the lines. Professor, good morning. Welcome.
Good morning, Lennox. To the Puna here. To the ground.
Good morning to you, sir.
To the ground report family and to Andy, I think. Lennox, I want to ask you a favor. After the show, could you contact me? You have my number, right?
Yes, I will.
Right, because it's important now, because I've been trying to get you all day yesterday, and Andy has...
Oh, yeah, I didn't have a phone. I didn't have a phone, so today I should have one, but I could use an alternative one.
Right. All right. Give me a call after the show now. It's important, right?
I certainly will.
All right, so listen to me. Let me get down to my thing.
We always anxious to hear your contributions.
It was horrendous. It is unbelievable when the police could use the state, when the police could use the state apparatus. The way how I see they treat the residents of Konopia and surrounding areas who were protesting for water yesterday. You saw that on the television, Lennox, last night? Hello? Hello?
Well, it was not the first time, remember, we announced here that there was something occurring. And it is alleged, and the matter is now before the police complaint authority. But go ahead.
This one, I think, well, I saw on the news last night, so I believe that was recent. I don't know if that matter has reached the police complaint authority and whoever. But when I tell you, it's disgraceful. People who pay in their water rate bill and what have you, who suffering as a consequence of no water, because water is life, and that you have water to carry out your daily function. And the way how these police and them hold these fellas and them and drag them on the ground like dog, Lennox. It is unbelievable. There ought to be a serious investigation into that, you know. I hope, man from the...
Yeah, definitely. People cannot... The police cannot be so rambunctious, cannot be so brutal, cannot be so insensitive. Possibly because probably they have water. That's the only conclusion I could do. But even in such circumstances, you cannot be so inhumane and utilize brute force in order to say that you are controlling the peace. Go ahead.
We don't have a high crime situation. What about if these fellas and them decide that they're going to take action? When I say action, otherwise then, you know, and go after these police and them. Because within recent time, you have seen so much things with police and prison officers and all of them being killed and army men and all kind of thing. What happened if these fellas and them now decide to say, me, it's revenge. Because well, what all do we? We didn't deserve that. We were protesting it was a legitimate right for not getting water. And the way all these police went about it. And I am calling for a thorough investigation. Although we know nothing ever happened, they go call, they go say, we go have an investigation. And up to now, you won't hear nothing going on. I'm concerned in that. But it was disgraceful. There was. Then also, you know, I listened to Elsina Rowley. But they're talking about a new bid for the refinery. You following it up, Lennox?
No, I said it briefly, but go ahead. I will take it from
well,
you.
Well, Lennox, let me tell you something. You know, when you up a gum tree, you will do everything to divert attention from people. And they're talking about they have a bid for the refinery and what have you and thing. And they're expecting, hopefully by this year, that this thing should be up and running and whatnot and whatnot. And you know who's one of the people that they included in the bid? OWTU, patriotic. Yeah? You see, these people really have any, as I tell you, they will divert the attention of people from all the nonsense that's taking place in this country. You understand? Now, again, I want to just show you, I see on the TV, the people in Cashew Gardens protesting. Who pays for their houses and whatnot, Lennox? The houses is incomplete. They get the keys and whatnot. When I say the house is complete, but there is no electricity connection in none of the houses.
Wow.
So could you imagine you giving people keys for the houses? The people say they have their appliances, the things, the stuff to move in, to carry it into the houses. And it's a woman with lamp and the children studying and whatnot. And no electricity, Lennox. What the hell really going on in this country? And finally, Lennox, I saw Rowley and them with Brian Lara and them too. Then they saw, I don't know if you saw it, I think it's the housing complex, I think by CGA was down there, I think it was, yeah? And you know
what?
You know what was laughable, boy, Lennox? Rowley said, you know, just like every other thing, we're going to put a football field, we're going to put all the sporting facilities, and one of it that's going to be inclusive in that is a golf course. When I hear it, I see this man
out of me. it irks me to listen to him, but that's a new one for me. Go ahead. Sorry about laughing.
I don't normally listen to hear no press conference or nothing like that. Because he does like to blast it much. And I can't face him. I can't see him. I can't hear him. Also to touch him or to smell him.
For a different reason, the TV is cut off when Dr. Rowley speaks. Because of what I would on a previous and a new different incarnation talk about is licentious and salacious conduct in the past, but you
every
go ahead.
Every time he talk, I pay on my TV. I just sanitize my TV. I just spray it with something because I can't bear to see that individual, that lying, a hateful character. You know, and you telling people about you going to put a golf course in a housing scheme in by CGA and whatnot and thing, and have who you think they have to with them, Brian Lara and these fellas and them. Let me tell you something, you know.
You give them a puppy show.
I only hope people in this country, regardless of what, Monday, the 18th of March, come out there by the hundreds of thousands. We can't wait for 2025 to have an election. We have to force them into an early election, calling an early election. Because by that time, you don't hear Imbo talking about IMS policies of what? Increasing the age for pension and increasing the pension contribution and whatnot. And by that time, the water rate, the electricity rate, the property, everything will be in full swing. and you're going to see the level of things they're going to take within this country, where people can't buy food, they can't pay for rent, and all kind of dotishness. You understand, Lennox? So it's going to be real. This, I'm telling you, as you say, this year will be a long hot summer. But let me see if Trinidad and Tobago, Trinbagonians, really love the country. You know, I want to, why I'm mentioning this thing with this water to hear the protest. I want to hear the Selwyn Kodjo, the Harvey Burris Center for Justice. I want to hear the Emancipation Support Committee. Because if Black boys that beat up, you know, I want to hear David Abdullah and them Black Lives Matters and whatnot. I want to hear them come out and make a statement on that. Don't only just think when something happens in America, this happening at home. And I just unbelievable the way how the police hold this man by the hand. Just walk up here, hold him by the arm and drag him down to the ground and swing him around like a dog, like a rag doll. And I am saying, if people, if them fellas take revenge, take the law into their own hand, I won't vex with them, you know. Because I'm telling you, no human, no police ain't with me, nothing like that. Regardless if you're police or whatnot. Because hear what? I will be coming after you if I have to dead in the process. Because you can't do me that when I fight in for justice. And it is my right for water. Water is life. And you treat me in that manner. And you yourself, the police, have all the blasted problems. We're only getting all the money and all the promotion and all the kind of nonsense within the police service. Eh? And all you do, treat it ordinary civilians, people who fighting for betterment for all you. And all you telling people, work with the police. You know this, and then we have a good relationship and what on this, all you treating people. Lennox, brother, don't forget, give me a call after the program now.
Yes, I will, of course. And you're quite right. I think your last comment is very valid. You cannot ask on the one hand for public cooperation, and then there is this public outcry consequential of what is ostensibly brutality and the use of unnecessary brute force.
And then before I go, somehow, not to say that the fellas was they was violent or they was offering any reason.
Yeah. But I'm talking about the image now of the police service.
You know, that so it's going to show that people who want to turn service a civilized society.
Yeah, I mean, it's simply not, it does not correspond with good relations.
Policing.
It doesn't correspond with good, image that the police wants to project to the public. And it simply is not conducive to cooperation by the public feeling comfortable to give the police
information
to address the burgeoning crime situation in the country. But thank you very much, of course,
okay,
for your
you
intervention.
Care.
Yes, indeed. Of course, we continue to take your calls, so don't forget. But those of you who have information, I don't have much details on the... Good morning.
Morning, Andy. My TK and Trinidad and Tobago. You know, long time, years gone by, right? We used to have, We used to have Diane Mahabi and Wyatt talking about the ills of children. But what goes on now? You ain't nobody coming out and talk about nothing in this country with about the level of nothing. You ain't what happened? Then these people are not exist anymore. Yeah? Long time they used to come out, now you ain't nothing going on in this country. Everything on wireless. Well, I never see more so much of crime in this country and nothing, nobody ain't saying nothing. All these on burners like before divers, many more, these three persons who die in Independence Square, nothing, all those things going on answers. Eh? Nothing have been going on here and hearing nothing about things. The old lady, 80-year-old woman, carnival time, how she get killed, nothing. And right now this government of this country want to say they go and build, or they go and take the little money we have to build buildings. Donkey years ago, all you keep on renting, all you keep on renting out places to house the ministry and all kind of things. Right now, they have no money to keep up in power, and all they want to tell me, all they're taking the little money they have here to one big building. What I'm wanting, really don't care about nobody in this country. Eh? Millions of dollars only to pay rent, only have enough time to build couple buildings. Take the money what only is to rent it and build buildings to house the ministry. Eh? All you want to tell me now in this day and age, this damn government season, where people going hungry, starving, dying, or you want to go and build buildings? Eh? Or you feel all you smart? Election, all of that is election, because you know all you have to leave office, all you have to leave this office. So all you're telling all you say, all you will build buildings now, and people and them will jump up and laugh and clap, and they will come all to all you. But I hope people, all you open all your eyes and see what's going on, because watch me, it's alleged. The pensioners and them, they're going to cut their little money just now. Nothing in this country, all you ain't getting free now. Just all you have to pay to go to the health services and them. You hear what I'm telling, all these have been alleged. I say so, it has been alleged. So put that in all this pipe and smoke it. When you think this government doing things to assist all you, they're doing nothing to assist all you, you know. They're doing that because the election coming and they want all you to say, hey, the government doing this, election. Look how much thing we're getting. That is what they're fooling all you. So open all your eyes out there and all your ears and see what this government destroying this country. And wrongly, all you have to get out, all you have to get out, because when we get in there and we start getting in, listen, man, we have to get the hands off and we have to put it aside. And all you will be telling to jail. You understand? With all these people during the COVID time, all you kill, all you have to get and make a jail for that. We're not taking that. We're not sitting down and take all what's going on in this country and all what are we doing to the poor man out here. We're struggling, eh? And all you have the benefit of the doubt. And we're telling people now to say something and do something. No, all you running the country, do what all you have to do. Do what all you come and tell us to say something and do something. All you do it, all you feel, all is God, all is not God, but when God ready for you, everybody will turn the devil away. Listen. What goes up comes down. All you want to be, all you want to stay so forever. I see sometimes when some of all you talking, all you feel all you is number one, eh? All you feel different now. That is just to tell you what goes up comes down. And a stronger believer, it will go right down. And UNC will come back and put things in order. We will put things in order and we will get out, because it's time for us to get out. All you destroying this country, all you running it down like the Gaza. Time for you to get out. Get out, man. What are you waiting on? We want to live, all you making us suffer. So get out now. Get out. I'm telling all you, get out. It's time. Run away.
Yesterday, you're talking to an unconscionable government, clearly under criminal enterprise called PNM. There's all the evidence to confirm that. Good morning. Good morning. We continue to take your calls. The lines are open. Just in case, of course, there is none yet, let me see that citrus close. project. We are concerned on the ground report about the contractor, the same improvised container office that we saw on the southern side of the house on the Tranquility Government Secondary School. The same containers we are assuming painted, of course, red and black. They even had the audacity. They didn't have the shame to, of course, change the paint, but it is there on that compound, and we suspect that Dr. Rowley and they are now, of course, in the process of generating their slush fund. Clearly, elections is in the air. Good morning. Good morning. Getting a challenge there? Yes, and we are extremely concerned. Yes. Oh, well, go ahead.
Yes, Trinidad and Tobago. Pleasant good morning again. This is all your boy, Carnage. Don't forget the 18th. Come out in all your numbers. And basically, workers, you see, workers, I talking to workers. Workers who working in the corporation. All you come out. All you, we are getting no money for 9 years. All you, it's time for we to come out. All you, why we working? We working for money. We working because we working by the sweat of thy brow. Thou shalt get pay. Thou shalt eat bread. And this government not giving us no bread. That is why the current situation out of hand. Because household not having money. The money not trickling down to the poorer class of people. Lennox, I have a little thing this morning. I would like Trinidad and Tobago to think. Right now, I want to say to Trinidad and Tobago and the opposition, please, all you listen to me. You see, we're going into election just now, 17 to 18 months now. Please, we want a proper candidate for Diego Martin West. So we have to come out in numbers and find a proper candidate and let a candidate start to work. Nomination April. And I believe the real man for that work. Because if he's a true soldier and you're fighting me down, you have no confidence in me, and you open a political party, the best man to fight is Dr. Rowley. I know it's my strategy wrong. I know it's my strategy wrong, and I believe if you go up and you fight Dr. Rowley's seat, I telling you, full confidence, 100%. I supporting you full 100. I bringing you through the trench and the valleys from Bagatelle to Shagaramas, right? And this person I calling on is Mr. Gary Griffith. Please, whatsoever problem all you have, fix it. Because we're watching it from now, and we want all it to start problem now. And if by God's grace, the government should change and the opposition should get into office. Me don't want nobody to all them going on that woman to fight on that woman like what they do Pandey and what they do them people. I don't want that, you know. Because I know it's people who looking to erase poverty like myself. So if all they want to negotiate, let me bring on Diego Martin West and after we go negotiate.
Now, yes, indeed, a very frank challenge. Good morning. We continue, of course, to take your calls. I see that Hope is on the move. They say that they don't want, they will not have any relations with the UNC. That's, of course, the party with Louis Leasing and former president of the Senate and Tishera as well as senior members or foundation members, if you want to call it that. But I would pay no mind to that. I think it is it has just nuisance value. And it will be, of course, a part of the consideration of the UNC, and of course, in its discussion. But I'm sure it will play a very minor or minute role in terms of influencing the outcome of the election. The fact of the matter is that the people have made a decision a long time ago, based on the facts that the PNM must go and the UNC must now regain its status, having regard to the fact that the PNM is responsible for it being in opposition, having regard to its propaganda, old talk, and unprovable accusations.
Yeah.
Good morning. Yes, good morning.
Good morning, good morning. I want to know something that we have left out. This special branch report that we had some time ago with Costa Cummins, we're not hearing about that. Now we hear SSA Bacchanal. Well, the SSA must be know everything. Rowley just threw that report aside. And next thing, this man called Clarence Rambarat, he left this country, he resigned and left this country. And he left making a statement that somebody on the executive was stealing land or land grabbing. We never hear nothing about that. All this is the bacchanal in the SSA. We want the SSA man to come out and tell me. Thank you.
And I agree implicitly. Good morning. We continue to take your calls. Yes, indeed. And of course, all the pronouncements of development that I take a bit infrastructural and, but I can say, material, civil engineering works for the EBC, for, of course, housing at Citrus Close. Let's go to the lines. Pleasant, good morning.
Lennox, to Napola here again. Sorry, I want to take a little second bite, please.
Yeah, no problem, man.
You know, last night I was watching the corridor transformation, the old rerun. And where you had Senator Wade Mark, and you know that clip that you highlighted, the appointment of the, well, you know what's frightening you, Lennox, you always hear me when I make my contribution, in due to the financial transaction, money laundering, white collar crime, and all these things, I always keep asking, where is the Security and Exchange Commission? And where is the Financial Intelligence Unit? Lennox, you can bear me out on that, brother? I always...
Yes, you have been tenacious in that regard, yes.
Right. But what was frightening is that when I heard Senator Mark last night saying that this guy that they put in charge of the Integrity Commission now, I don't get the name of him, but he was the man in charge of the Security and Exchange Commission. Am I right that what I heard, Lennox?
Yes, the head of the Integrity Commission now, yes.
Right. So therefore, what the hell, you moving somebody who ineptitude, who corrupt and who is a part of the PNM, because your failure to deal with any matters as it relates to, you know, financial impropriety by the PNM government, you have failed to deal with any matter, go make any comment or anything like that. And now they have moved you from the Security and Exchange Commission and put you in charge of the Integrity Commission. A role that is just as critical or even more critical because you have to deal with people to ensure that, you know, transparency, accountability and all these things takes place. And where people could be making jail, including that of the Prime Minister and his members of government and big business people. Because why I'm saying this, you know, I have seen amount of resignation and retirement taking place from within Nilan Massey. I saw the Jove fella. Now I see there's another fella there again, saying, apart from the lady who, the whistleblower. So you've seen people, I want to believe, that there's a lot of fraudulent activities taking place with this government in partnership with Massey. Because just recently, I see Massey went into a joint ventureship with the government and the National Gas Company business and what have you. But because of people speaking out and whatnot, and fingers pointing in that direction, that Massey and all these people, these big conglomerates, are part of a mafia, a brotherhood of wrongdoers, and all these things, conspiracy to defraud this country under fraudulent circumstances, money laundering and white collar crime and all this kind of thing. You've seen so much resignation coming out from Massey. And I am saying that there ought to be a thorough investigation. And we have to lament that, this, according to Senator Mark, this man must resign, the head of the Integrity Commission. Because here it is, they didn't renew the fellow who they had there before, his contract at the Integrity Commission. Which they deservedly so. They had a right to kick him out. Right. To the professor fella. Because here why? Them fellas sit on their backside and get a fat salary and wasn't doing nothing. And not because they don't get back your job and think you want people to protest and to think in sympathy with you and what that. No. They have a job to do it, regardless of who it affects. And then you remember there was a thing about the investigation with Ines Gate, with Keith Rowley and whatnot and thing. Do you think, and then you look at what are the close relationship that he is next door to Bridget and he said George and Warner. And all of these fellas, Rowley, all of them, his neighbors. So could you imagine all the information of people in this country, especially people who oppose the government, the opposition, as well as other people? Their business will be discussed, you know, in a room. because they're next door neighbors. And all these people, private and personal and confidential information will be discussed there. And the matter with the INS gate, all that could just fall by the wayside. No investigation. So what you see here, Lennox, is no ordinary thing. And this is one time I always say that I applaud Keith Rowley for speaking the truth when he said we are a brotherhood of wrongdoers. It's a mafia. And we keep each other secret. And if you expose us, we're going to kill you politically and what and we just laugh and take that as ordinary, Lennox. This country sit down, no part of the world. And then you talk about you have to make the rich get richer and all that kind of thing. Let me tell you something. Keith Rowley, you would have been exiled all now because they would have hunted you down. You would have had to get out of office. And by any means necessary, people would have seen that way. Not that I am using violence, but what you have in, you have fostered and festered onto these people of this country, Lennox. And now you're putting a next man again, the head of the Integrity Commission, where people from the government who ought to be investigated, big business people and all them kind of thing, what they're doing, the banks and the insurance and all these big companies, conglomerates, who getting away with murder. And the Security and Exchange Commission said absolutely nothing. The Financial Intelligence Unit said nothing. The Integrity Commission, nobody said nothing. And now you're taking these people, from you're just shifting them around like a chess game and putting them into higher office when they could use all your for protectionism, Lennox. I am saying this, we ought to have, let me see if this, and you see, he went on further that to attack the judges, the judiciary. We're saying the judiciary is partly responsible. He blamed Kamala and them for crime. He blamed the citizens for crime. He blamed everybody, the police for crime and all that thing. Here now you're attacking the judges and saying that the judges on them, in terms of how they pass judgment and whatnot, it seems to be the favor of the criminals and whatnot. And these people who we expect to come out and speak out, the judges and the whole judiciary, the law association and whatnot, nobody is saying nothing enough. When you see, when the small man see that there is no justice, and those who are in authority and getting big pay, and they're standing up for the rights and the salary that they get in to defend this country, they're going to take it all.
Right, okay. Well, thank you very much, of course, for your contribution. Of course, we go for a short break. And when we come back more, yes, your argument is valid. The former, of course, Integrity Commission Chairman, Rajendra Ram Logan, he was surprised that the matter of judicial review in terms of funding for that entity was withdrawn as a first measure under this new, of course, chairman. So the conspiracy is no longer a theory, but it's a fact in Trinidad and Tobago. We'll examine these and more as we return after the break. This is the Ground Report.
The Ground Report with Mikey Kay, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
Looking for top quality and affordable hardware supplies? Then look no further than Midland Hardware, number 97 Eastern Main Road, Arouca. We stock a wide range of tools, water tanks, blocks, lumber, steel, and everything you need for your home and business project. Check out our new display of steel windows and assorted designs of metal curtain rods. Midland also stockpiles sand, gravel, topsoil, and more. We have a variety of kitchen faucets, face basins, and toilet sets, bathroom mat sets, all garden tools, hand tools, generators, power washers, and water pumps. Customers can make payments via links, credit card, online payment, and cash on delivery. WhatsApp 327-7761 for free quotation, or give us a call at 646-2144. Open every day, Sunday to Sunday, from 8 a.m. From foundation to finish, it's all at Midland.
For over 100 years, radio has been the most accessible, and to date, it's still the most listened to medium everywhere. More FM 104.7 is programmed so you can hear us everywhere. Never miss a beat. This station and its programming is fit for the listeners everywhere with the most variety in Trinidad and Tobago. You are guaranteed to reach your target market with More FM 104.7. Get more sales, get more clients, book your ads today by calling us 221-4913.
A lucky homeowner will win a brand new car. Yes, a brand new Mitsubishi Expander Cross. Yes, park in your four-vehicle parking space. Limited availability. Get in a gear with DG Home's newest gated community, Daniel Estate. The oasis of Canopia will satisfy your needs for a new lifestyle. Beautifully designed, three bedrooms, two baths, modern interior, sophisticated finishings with superbly manicured landscaped green spaces, front and backyard included, starting at $1.65 million. Call now and book a viewing. 691-5659. Beautiful home, beautiful car, beautiful life. Home is DG Homes, Daniel Estate, Canopia.
Hey, you!
Yes, you!
Need quality printing at affordable prices? Then look no further! At Graphic Source, we've got you covered! Take your project to the next level for all your designs and printing needs! From t-shirt printing to labels, signs, and banners! Look no further! Business stamps, flyers, tickets, and invites, just to name a few! With two convenient locations, Eastern Main Road, St. Augustine, opposite Massey's Doors, and Arima Shopping Center, Broadway Street, Arima! Contact us today! 342-2664-27 00428 or 360-8917. Graphic Source, your number one source. You name it, we design it and print it.
Get ready to board the Harbor Master. Easter Sunday night for Howie T annual boat cruise. Clash of Generations. Sunday, 31st March.
Bring your badness and come. I want you to bring your badness and come. Come again.
Boarding 11 p.m. Sailing 12 midnight. Dress elegantly in orange and black. Featuring Angel Journey, Digital Dice, King Kabuki, and the Hitman, Howie T.
Here welcome to King of the Dancehall.
Tickets at $200. Get them now at Sion's Bar San Fernando. Como Barbershop, Busy Corner Mall, Shagunas. Bobby's Bar, Q-Rap, Caliente Bar, Q-Rap, Fats International, Trin City Mall, and Arima. New Luna Bar, Aruka. Revive Beauty Bar, McCoy Lights, Ben's Hideaway, Pinto Road, Arima. Roadside Cafe San Juan, Amanda's Grill, Excellent City, Port of Spain, and the Sour Sour Team, the Hitman, Howie T, annual boat cruise, Clash of Generations.
Me on the Balancing Beer from down the 90s.
Love the vibes, where you bring.
Sunday, 31st March, get ready to board the Harbor Master. Easter Sunday night, 104.7 FM is the official station for Clash of Generations.
More music festival.
Yes, indeed. We are back. The time check is just about 16 minutes past the hour of 7 o'clock. And we continue, of course, to take your calls. Of course, we got a response from the corporation, the Port of Spain Corporation. When Mikey comes in, of course, he will give you the details. Let me just read for you what was requested of the corporation. We said, of course, that letter was dated the 26th of the second month of February 2024. Chief Executive Officer copied, of course, to the mayor himself. And it says, in brief, subject application for use of Woodford Square on Monday, the 18th March 2024 from 12 noon to about 3 p.m. To highlight and discuss general matters of public interest for which our organization was designed and committed to addressing via dialogue. Of course, this is coming from the pushback movement steering committee. Their CEO, of course, the above entity, in conjunction with and the cooperation with, of course, the stakeholders, United Movement, the Ground Reporter, Sense and Sensibility, the Mobile Avatar Improvement Organization, Trade School, and concerned citizens for the maintenance of our democracy, rule of law, and separation of powers, have organized a public gathering designed to address multiple socio-economic and psycho-cultural matters that are of national, community, and individual import. Indeed, consequential of anecdotal and granular, intense discourse on the environment, economy, politics, our democracy, and overall welfare as a community and a nation. We believe the time has come for a mass interaction or interactive and participatory exercise. Having completed our many and manifold community awareness outreach programs, we believe the time has come for an open plenary session, which is the sign qua non, meaning that the precursor for this request application to the corporation. We expect that there will be conditionalities for the use of the square, which we are prepared to oblige. We therefore will be in need of an electricity supply to facilitate the PA system. Note, date of event, Monday, 18th March, 2024. Time of commencement, 12 noon. Time of termination, around 3 p.m. Your kind facilitation will be greatly appreciated. Expecting your early response, sincerely, Lennox Smith, on behalf of the Pushback Movement. A copy, His Worship, the Mayor of Port of Spain. So that is the content of it. Of course, as you know, we do not need any permission from the police, according to law, to assemble in a public place. What we need permission for is a march. And of course, when we assemble at 10 o'clock on Monday, opposite to the Baranara, opposite Express on the Baranara Promenade, we head west. That is the arrangement. That is the itinerary. West to the financial complex, and then, of course, to the DPP, the Director of Public Prosecutions. And then from there, by 12 o'clock, we should be in the square. That is, of course, the plan. As I said, of course, Mikey will give you a little more when he comes in terms of where we are. That being as it may, we go back to the lines. A pleasant good morning to all and sundry once again. And let me give you the numbers for the new callers. 229-0251. 229-0251. 239-5120. 239-5120. And, of course, WhatsApp. In the comfort of your home, you can drop us a line. We will certainly air it during the course of the program. 366-3053. 366-3053. Let me say once again, I cannot overemphasize Andy will be with us shortly. Overtures are being made by Mikey. And when Mikey says something, better button than it is not. So, of course, he's in good spirits. That is to say, Andy. And I can tell you that he is rearing, and as far as I'm concerned, I myself would like to go on a short vacation. So I'm hoping that he comes out sooner rather than, but if it is that he feels that not yet, it's up to him, of course, because we love him so much that we will make this necessary sacrifice. But at the same time, there is a financial requirement. He has not asked us to, of course, advocate on his behalf. He's too proud, and his independence is too valuable to him, but we believe that we should do that. And that is to say, drop a little envelope for him, cash or whatever it is. Once again, I want to thank, of course, that good Samaritan, that patriot, as he is typically called, for, of course, assisting me with that telephone, that cell phone yesterday about 5 o'clock, just before the corridor transformation. Yeah, last night I had to correct it. So we had a kind of silent corridor transformation last night. That shows that videos played would have been of edification to you. But of course, I suspect that by today we should get back the telephone contact, and things should be honky-dory, so to speak. That being as it may, We go back to the lines and we take your calls. The lines are open. Yes, indeed. And as I was saying, I will be interrupted. Appropriate. Oh, we have a caller. Good morning. Is it my ears? Oh, I'm not getting too well tonight, this morning or what? All right, let me see. Yes. All right, so, of course, all right, good morning. Welcome.
Yes, Lennox, I again.
Yes.
No, we have it tanked. We had it, in spite of everything, we had it tanked too. Every morning you get up and you reach there early. Sometimes I always washing my car. You unset already. So we have to thank you too. We have to thank Mr. Amal for giving us his eyes, his ears, and his everything, for having us there so we could come out and we could say something. So we want to thank him, thank Mr. and Mrs. Amal and family for that. You understand? Because every morning we come and we talk, we say what we had to say. So remember Mr. Amal too. Right? And we get permission. I already said we get permission. That is very good. You see, God is sleeping. God is around watching.
Go ahead. Finish what you have to say, then I will respond.
All right. Well, I only was talking about the square now, so which means we got permission for that. Yeah?
Go ahead. Are you finished?
So we had to say thanks for that, because God is watching. And I thank God for that. So we all could come out on the 18th, which is Monday coming. Come out in all the numbers on the 18th and come out and just bring out family, bring out four, bring out auntie, mama, grandma, everybody on the 18th. The more come out is better. We coming out in our numbers. Please, Trinidad and Tobago, come out, because what is going on in this country, it has to stop. So come out in all the numbers. That is all I could tell all you. At 10 o'clock, I think it is, come out. Brian Lara Pominard, come out in all the numbers. I will be there, looking forward to seeing all the numbers. Bless everybody, Monday, come out, please.
Yes, and let me thank you very much, because let me categorically reiterate what I said. I said that there is a response, and that Mikey, when he comes on, he will, of course, elaborate. So, and what I did, I read out the request that was made since Sunday 26th of last month. So I want to be very, 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 very clear. So when Mikey comes, he will, of course, give you a little more details as to where we are going. That being as it may, of course, we continue to take your calls, and don't forget, of course, the numbers to call: 229-0251, 229-0251, 239-5120, 239-5120, and of course WhatsApp us at 366-3053, 366-3053, and don't forget, of course, after the program to give Andy a call, and of course leave something in an envelope for him. I can't overemphasize, of course, my appreciation by that good Samaritan, that, of course, patriot, who, of course, delivered it to me, that cell phone, my own, of course, being displaced in the clutter of the moving to George Street, where I am at this present time. A pleasant good morning to you.
Hey, Lennox, morning, boy.
Yay, good morning.
Hey, yes. Morning to me. Lennox, I just put on the pipe here. They have no water. Now imagine people getting their children ready to go to school, right? And to go to work, and they have no water. But already one with his consult at all. He come in hot and sweaty, criticize everything Basio Pandey do. And all of you know, if Pandey didn't build that desalination plant, I would not be talking to you, and you would not be talking to me. In other words, all of you are dead already from thirst. Just imagine that. And I listened to him for James last night. confirm everything what you been saying, you have been saying, you know. We only could forget about them two seats in Tobago. That's same with Valley. And he said, Kamala Party well prepared. He said, we're holding a call no election. Because he ain't finding favor with nobody in Tobago, nor in Trinidad. So he ain't sure we're going to call an election. He also say that, what did he say, boy? Well, as far as he controls Lennox, he said, Kamala has the party well prepared. He has well prepared. If he call it, his legs, and this is a bandana mohit, chastise the commissioner of police because she from surveillance. And look at the state of the place. She also tell him about discrimination, what going on with this who getting work and who ain't getting the usual thing now.
Yes.
Yeah, the only person I want to talk about is Robert Montano, because enough. When you pull it up, you go see. Like something going wrong with him. I think my team will bring him back on the program again. But as it stands right now, all what you said, I hear it for James talk. And if Rowdy ready for the self-call call the election, I hear saying 28th, we might get more. I don't know. You're going to use your man on the ground. So you're going to let me know. I got to hear you get back on phone. Right? Because you need about four phones, you know. The amount of people want to call you and contact you. But you're going to pull up open for James Taylor.
Yes, I will certainly. I certainly will. Yeah.
All right then.
And of course, no, these days with the technology, no need for four phones. You can have a two and three, of course, SIM card. I say these days, you don't have to have three and four phones. That's a long time. On one phone, you have two and three SIM cards. So you can have three different phones on one device. That's the point I was making. Yeah. So yes, you are right. I need more than one phone, and one cell phone will, of course, accommodate. That being as it may, of course, let's go to the next caller. Yes, the PNM, of course, is in shambles. Good morning.
Morning, Lennox. How are you going?
I'm fine in the circumstance.
This morning I was listening to our radio, a TV station, and they said they have an avenue where you could object to the property tax as an individual household. I want to know how true that is, and if it is true, if it had necessary forms to fill out and who you're sending it to. I don't know if you could do some research into that.
Yeah, but I can tell you off the cuff, yes. In terms of location, logistics, operationalization, well, that is where I'll have to do some work, because this government have a way of placating people by making these gestures, but they really don't mean it.
And yeah, everybody know that.
I will not be surprised that even though they would make the announcement. Yeah, so the law says so. Yes, the law says that you can object. So I know that for a fact. But whether or not there is the institution, that is the issue. So I'm going to look into that.
Yeah, because John, public need to know if they need to.
Yeah.
To object, then we need to know where to go, right? Because had I had to with Trevor, XYZ, whatever. Oh, one more thing, or two more things before I go. I hear no researcher. Okay, not researcher. Hello?
He's around, but he's a man in demand. You know what? He's a man in demand. He's around, but of course, his time is being consumed. You wouldn't believe. He's really working hard, and of course, much of the information that we would have had to confirm, he would have had on his plate as well. And where it is appropriate and convenient for him, we normally would deploy him. But you know, Andy is more inclined to engage his attention from time to time. So I await with bated breath, of course, Andy to return, so that we can get a little more frequent presence or inputs from researcher number one.
Right, but and one more thing, Lennox, I emphasize on this already, maybe one, two times. We need to put a time frame for callers, because some callers just keep on rattling on and don't take a breath. You understand?
Oh, yes.
Contribution is a good one, you know. But we need to be, like I said, short and sweet. right?
Yeah, yeah, I agree with you. I agree with you. Yeah, and sometimes we indulge because of the nature of the discourse. So we too may be, maybe guilty of prolonging. Yes. So we are going to take note of that. That is a good programming, should I say, stricture that we must implement.
All right. I'm sure other people share this. Other people share the same thing. Anyhow, thanks for taking the call.
Yes. And all right, thank like you I for said, calling. Yeah.
Yeah, man. Okay. All right. I listened to that program about 8 or 9 years now. Non-stop.
All right. Very good. Yes, indeed. Of course, we continue to take your calls. Yes, we continue to take your calls.
All right. Thanks. All right, okay. Brother.
Yeah, certainly looking to, of course, that question of where you can get your objections to property tax evaluation.
Good morning to you, Enoch Smith.
Good morning to you as well, my friend.
Yeah, good morning to you. And good morning to the listeners at 104.7. Good morning to Mikey K. Good morning to Andy Williams. Good morning to Obi. And that is what the last caller had to do. I'm very ashamed of that. You cannot make a contribution for 2 or 3 minutes. You have to ask questions to find out what's going on. Don't dwell, brother. Still focus on the issue. And the issue is being rowdy. Because when Miss Sarah's calling you, she has a lot to say. When Miss Woodbrook calling you, she has a lot to say. When Kingsley calling you, he has a lot to say. When Anderson calling you, he has a lot to say. When Carnage calling you, they have a lot to say. So let me do this. Don't go down that road. Please. It had the guns that bust plenty shots. It had the guns that bust one shot. Okay? Some is machine. Plenty. So let me go down that road. Call in and make a contribution. You study who is still long and who is staying long. The point remain, Longsmith. Yes. I'll make it clear to all on Sunday. There is no election in the UNC at this time. Any election in the UNC is calling a general election for Dr. Rowley to go. Come July, October, November, coming this year, there's no internal executive election in the UNC at this time. By law, there will be none. So all excited and gathering up to go and contest the executive, what they know. I said, back down. Wait your turn. Wait your turn. This is not a hungry thing, you know. So everybody hungry for power. Kingsley don't want to be a councillor, you know. Kingsley don't want to be an MP, you know. The guy make it nice, you know. Kingsley don't want to own no public office in this country. See, what are you doing here? I'm good at that. This is what I'm good at. And to cipher these snakes and them who calling in. To have a problem with callers staying long. Understand? That's what I got about. So we on focus. Our focus is to make Dr. Rowley call a general election this year. That's what we focus in. We focus to go and say it's an internal election. No. We in an election mood. And when we're in an election mood, no party election must call. No party election must call. That's my point of view. And I know, my understanding, that in the UNC constitutional law, it also, and I stand to be corrected, that when is the election time, that no internal election must call any party. So, we focus on the issue. We focus. But as I close again, I want to tell Dr. Rowley this. We in an election mood. We are getting up. One of the biggest elections this country ever see. I want to put you on notice. Stop playing soul in this country. Stop going a shovel in a hand and playing the damn fool. Stop it. We are in election mood. Is it that it's campaign and kickback Dr. Rowley playing for? Better ask the question now. Because we are in election mood, and every time I turn the TV or go on social media, he have a shovel in his hand just so. After 9 years, after man running the tones all over the place. Dr. Rowdy, hold up until after the election. We ain't know how this election will go down in Trinidad and Tobago. We don't know how it will go down in Trinidad and Tobago. You cannot, because every story turn now, it will be under investigation when my party, UNC, come in power. We're going to stop all the projects because we don't trust you. You're a lawyer on all the boards. That you the cut. We take and put it under your ministry in the Prime Minister office day. We want, we, that has, we have got a independent in you the cut. When the axis declare your wealth, only remove a man. Only remove a man when they ask you to declare your wealth. So how the hell now? How the hell now? You all over the country want to turn sour and turn sour. Dr. Rowdy, stop turn sour. I want to put the police on notice. Anytime for the year again. Anytime again, Dr. Rowdy go and turn sour, I come to take the shovel away from him. He's going to take the shovel away from Dr. Rowley. He's not going to turn no more so in this country in election mood. I went in the airport to make a citizen arrest already, no. And I was stuck on the highway. I also make an attempt to go and lie down on the highway when he was coming back from the airport. My mother called me. Dr. Rowley, I will take a insult charge. I don't know, is it a charge? But I will take that charge. I will come to take the shovel away from you. Stop turning sour in this country. We are in election mood. It's going to be kickback after kickback after kickback. You go and open, after 9 years, you know, government, the old Ramban to do what? To play games? To play hiring them little black boys from ghetto and play them something now? We know it's a campaign move. And now we're talking about, the youth camp and the boot camp and the youth camp. After a year, we know which Aranguez to open some boot camp. After nine years. So we stay focused on the general election. So I put Dr. Rowdy on notice. Also, I will make it clear. Come November the 5th, after United States of election, that Jargon deal will be under investigation by the FBI. I tell this country, we need to remove Rowdy fast to save our country from sanction. The only person who can save our country is Kamala Prasad Bisesa. Because under Trump, she's clean. Under Trump, Trump don't want to pattern Rowdy. Lennox Smith, you might have an idea that the U.S. General Secretary come here about and call the leaders of the Caribbean to make some peace against Haiti because some youngsters and killers take over Haiti because they are saying that the Prime Minister in Haiti is that the Prime Minister in Trinidad only dealing with the 1% and feeding the 1%. Today in Trinidad, we live like North Korea. We living like we in our next zone. We in the matrix. We seeing money for all kind of big buildings and all kind of Dr. Rowdy Law, you get all kind of big money and do have money to pay the poor. Why Dr. Rowdy, as we the leading many resources in the Caribbean, we the small America, how the pay them that say. Why Dr. Rowdy wasn't there? Or why nobody from representation wasn't there in the meeting between and he the third man line up. In case the president died in the States, he the third man who took over the presidency. And he was here, he fly on the Air Force One, come in the Caribbean, Barbados leader, St. Vincent leader. Where was we leader? America. I'm telling you, don't feel. America is looking into Dr. Rowley. And when Trump come, because Trump's asking how the hell America could be countries the okay to that was Trump asking how the hell America could be given bribe to small countries to deal business with a terrorist, with a man who wanted, with a drug lord. If If November comes and Dr. Lee stay the prime minister, I do not know the country where we come together, where we ask for a peaceful election in this country, because we will be under sanction. If Trump return, when Trump return November the 5th, he's coming out country because of Dr. Rowley. I want to thank you very much, gentlemen.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Of course, somebody asked earlier, if we don't have a caller, let me just make this interjection. I'll give way to the caller if there is one. Somebody asked a question where you can deposit, of course, your objections to notice of valuation. Well, according to the information I have before me, you can do so online at valuationdivision.gov.tt or at any one of the following offices of the following. At the following locations. Barataria, of course, head office. Incidentally, that's a building that is owned by Al-Rawi and his family. Barataria, Churchill Roosevelt Highway. And of course, Tonopuna, Arima, Sangre Grande, Chaguanas, Princess Tongue, San Fernando, Point Fortin, Superior, Tobago. So there you have it. In terms of that, you write a letter to them indicating your objections. We go to the lines. Don't forget the numbers to call. These numbers are as follows. 229-0251, 229-0251, 239-5120. Let's go straight to the lines. Good morning. Welcome.
Yeah, Lennox. Morning.
Lennox. Good morning.
Yes. I'm coming out to say what it is I say here this morning. Mm-hmm. Let things, you know, it's not only them have to talk on this program. And he can't bully nobody on this program. Right? According to the person before, everybody must have a limited time to talk. Kingsley cannot bully nobody. This is not Kingsley program. And at a certain time, Mr. Amaro didn't want him on the program. So Kingsley can't bully nobody. Everybody has a contribution to make to this program. That is why they want everybody to come out on Monday, please God. It's not Kingsley alone coming out. Thank you.
Yes, indeed, of course. And, well, of course, in this program, we defend the right for anybody to speak. However, we may disagree, but of course, we defend to the hilt your right to speak. So, but of course, that was an opinion. You have expressed yours, a counter one. Well, of course, in between there, we should find some kind of compromise. We continue, of course,
to
take your calls.
Good morning, Lennox.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning. It's Newbie. Good morning. It's Newbie. I want to play the ads. Let's pay some bills, and we'll come back to the calls, right?
Yes, indeed, of course. People, of course, don't forget, it's getting hot in here. But, of course, we have to pay some bills. And when we come back more on this edition of the Ground Report.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
The rainy season is here, so be weather smart and change your tires to handle the nation's wet roads. After all, you don't want to be the one to cause any accidents, do you? So why not check out Racetrack Wheels right now? They're the only one that gives you quality tires to hold the road properly. And to top it off, Racetrack Wheels carries all sizes of tires for all makes of vehicles. They are the sole distributors for Saylan and Achilles tires. These tires carry a full manufactured warranty and is the number one tire for comfort and performance in this rainy weather. We have the latest rims and all sizes, all at drastically low prices. We also do blank wheels that could be drilled to your vehicle specification. It's all about new technology and keeping ahead of the game.
So hurry on down to Racetrack Wheels, three locations: 330 Eastern Main Road, Arouca; 82 Bethany Road, Buco, Tobago; and 64th Southern Main Road, Chase Village. Or call 285-9168.
So my friend, take it from me and be weather smart this season and change your tires right now at Racetrack Wheels.
For over 100 years, radio has been the most accessible, and to date, it's still the most listened to medium. Everywhere, More FM 104.7 is programmed so you can hear us everywhere. Never miss a beat. This station and its programming is fit for the listeners everywhere, with the most variety in Trinidad and Tobago. You are guaranteed to reach your target market with More FM 104.7. Get more sales, get more clients. Book your ads today by calling us. 221-4913.
Get ready to board the Harbor Master. Easter Sunday night for Howie T annual boat cruise, Clash of Generations. Sunday, 31st March.
Bring your badness on, come. I want you to bring your badness on, come. Come again.
Boarding 11 p.m. Sailing 12 midnight. Dress elegantly in orange and black.
featuring Angel Journey, Digital Dice, King Kabuki, and the Hitman, Howie T.
Kitty Howie T.
Welcome to King of the Dancehall.
Tickets at $200. Get them now at Sion's Bar San Fernando, Como Barbershop, Missy Corner Mall, Chagones, Bobby's Bar, Q-Rap, Caliente Bar, Q-Rap Fans International, Trin City Mall, and Arima, New Luna Bar, Aruka, Revive Beauty Bar, McCoy Lights, Ben's Hideaway, Pinto Road Arima, Roadside Cafe San Juan, Amanda's Grill, Excellent City Porter's Bay, and the Sour Sour Team, The Hitman, Howie T, Annual Boat Cruise, Clash of Generations.
Me and the band of CBS from down the 90s.
I love the vibes where you bring.
Sunday, 31st March, get ready to board the Harbor Master. Easter Sunday night, 104.7 FM is your official station for Clash of Generations.
A lucky homeowner will win a brand new car. Yes! A brand new Mitsubishi Expander Cross. Yes, park in your four-vehicle parking space. Limited availability. Get in a gear with DG Home's newest gated community, Daniel Estate. The oasis of Canupia will satisfy your needs for a new lifestyle. Beautifully designed, three bedrooms, two baths, modern interior, sophisticated finishings, with superbly manicured and landscaped green spaces, front and backyard included, starting at $1.65 million. Call now and book a viewing. 691-5659. Beautiful home, beautiful car, beautiful life. Home is DG Homes, Daniel Estate, Canupia.
Put food on your table. ADC is affordable. Shop at ADC Supermarket Cleaver Road. A very comfortable and clean environment. These prices are unbelievable. Come see for yourself. We have the best alcohol prices. Don't miss out.
Get those specials on liquor.
Put food on your table with ADC Supermarket, conveniently located at number 4 Cleaver Road in Arima. Every Friday and Saturday is real vibes and live entertainment from your very own DJ Christian on Friday and Saturday. Everyone is talking about ADC Supermarket. Shop in comfort and in a clean environment with the best prices for all your grocery needs. Secured parking. Remember, free delivery. Put food on your table. ADC is affordable. ADC Supermarket, number 4 Cleaver Road in Arima.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
Yes indeed. We are back. Yes indeed. Time check. It's just about 10 minutes to the hour of 8 o'clock. And of course, we continue to take your calls. We go to the phone lines immediately. I hope that I don't have to recall them or regurgitate or repeat them. But out of an abundance of caution, let me just say, say that 229-0251, 229-0251, and of course 239-5120, 239-5120, and of course WhatsApp, don't forget 366-3053, 366-3053, and of course after the program, leave Andy a line, of course, of come back, you know, plead, because of course I need a rest, I can tell you that. I'm not only deserving, but I think you know, there are times when, of course, you feel mentally and intellectually exhausted and you need, of course, to have some kind of reviver. Friday alone is not sufficient. All right, people, I know tomorrow is Friday, but Friday is not sufficient. All right, so the numbers I've given you, so please make your calls as we continue to look at these issues. Yes, I agree with Pinky and the other callers who said that his Dr. Rowley's sudden flurry of the effervescence, the dynamism of the Twitter, because he's talking about projects for 2020, etc. And I think one that is very hilarious, and that is, of course, that of building up HTC headquarters. If you go on the site now, you will see, of course, something called, I think, 2025. And it suggested that it is that piece of land is supposed to be, of course, maybe high rise, just as what they're doing at Citrus Close. But instead, really, at another sun turning ceremony, I think it's the same one at at Citrus Close, it is called, mentioned that the AGC headquarters will be constructed. And then, of course, mentioned at the same time the headquarters of the Social Service Ministry on Tragridge Road. But of course, we and the ground report, I myself was responsible for that aspect, monitoring the construction of the monstrosity called Balize House and the multi-million dollar sudden erection of that, what I consider to be edifice of corruption and nepotism, because Dr. Obi said at the beginning of his tenure as leader of the party and as opposition leader, that what he was confronted with by the bank, by a particular bank, is that the party was owing $4 million and a number of hundred thousands by either what is known today as TTT and other creditors. And here it is suddenly after 9 years of the Rowley administration, you have a multi-million dollar monstrosity being constructed of steel, mortar, etc. And that could only tell one story, similar to, of course, the disquiet in the national community with respect to the evisceration of that particular piece of legislation that talks about integrity and trying to maintain the integrity of the processes that for government procurement, in other words, the procurement legislation under the number of recusal. Well, in the former case, that is to say the HDC head office matter, he simply says that the workers' bank unsightly presence was torn down. You know, he never mentioned the larger portion of land where people were living, ordinary people were living, and they forced them to move out, and they evicted them. And they evicted them whilst they were living there.
Lennox?
Demolition.
And Lennox
simply moved in from HGC under the instructions, clearly, of this fella, Noel Garcia. And started to take out windows and ceilings and galvanize, etc. And the people had to cry and beg for extension at minimum. And that was not given. It's like a case to where, to get rid of the pigeon, you mash up the coop. That is what transpired. Rowley never mentioned that. So that is to show you how deliberate, how focused, how clinical he is in terms of attempting to attempt at self-aggrandizement for political gains and political accession, while trying to play down his iniquities, which of course is overwhelming.
Lennox, you have a call on the line.
Therefore, the concept and the idea that evil cannot prevail over good, or put another way, we must accept money. Good morning. Speak a little louder. I didn't catch that.
You don't know about the line, boy, the locks.
Oh, sorry about that.
I was trying to say.
I thought no one would.
No. You need more time to go and dance. Don't make joke, boy. If people need to hear your voice, everyone on this program, you know. Right? And on the corridor transformation in the night. You can't leave the people high and dry, so I'm making joke with you. The point is, what I'm going to tell you is...
I know that.
Yeah, you... I feel you're going to call the election. Too much analysis on this thing, eh? And Rowley, I never really feel you're doing a good work. When you hear them talk, it's as though, well, you know, we is it. So I still feel you're going to call the election anytime. Now, let me tell you something. I'm going to talk about cricket here now. You see all this modern day cricket with the blade? And so they're making all these kind of fancy shots.
Yes.
The first man ever make a shot like that in cricket was unorthodox, you know. And was considered he and Juan Carlin, Gary Sobers, as the greatest batsman in the world. He jumped up in the air in the oval, high up, and hit a ball over slips. And people say, what kind of shot is that, boy? Gary Jovers invented them shot a long time with that fellas playing now, you know. And he was never technically correct, but bat and pad close together and all of that, you know. Unorthodox.
Right.
And he ended up being he and Kanai and Combs. Similar, the greatest batsman in the world. Kanai was technically correct. There are no analysis in that, what did I say? He was correct. Man went on to be the greatest batsman in the world. So all these analysts who say this, blah, 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 they will call the election, you know. You know it, and I know it. I'm gone with that.
Yes. But yes, indeed. We continue to take your calls, of course, and as I said, deliberate and deceptive as per usual, and very, what I consider to be eclectic with his, of course, information only to promote his party that is extremely devious, wicked. Good morning.
Yeah, Lux. Do you know that since 2017, with all this madness Imbert has come out with, since 2017, they freeze employment in the public service. So that is less money people retiring and going, nobody else getting work, and that is less money they had to pay. Since 2017, let the country know that. Thank you.
Yes, yes, that's a fact, because that will be surely a campaign issue as well. Yeah, they have freezed, of course, employment in the public service. Good morning. Yes, of course, more information on persons willing to oppose the valuation that they would have been given. As I said earlier, the different offices that you can go by, write a note and a letter to them saying that you object. But of course, it continues to say that there's another situation as well. You have, of course, 30 days from the date on which you either receive or the date on the valuation to, of course, issue your notice of rejection, all right, or objection, I should say. All right, so that's another piece of information coming out from that question that was asked by a caller previously. We continue to take your calls. Pleasant good morning. Lines are open.
The lines are open, but get them back in numbers again.
All right, okay. 229-0251. 229 for the new callers, 229-0251. And of course, the other number to call, 2395120, 2395120, and WhatsApp, 366-3053. 366-3053. And don't forget, of course, to leave a little line for Angela. Good morning.
Good morning. They don't have to write to the valuation office. The valuation office has an objection form that you have to fill out there.
Oh, all right. So you have an objection form. All right. Thank you very much. I didn't get that from my information. So that's why I was looking for that as well. So thanks for that clarification. I'm still going to confirm it, but thanks very much.
The notes of assessment from Inland Revenue is the one you have to do handwriting. You have to write to them and tell them you object to the Inland Revenue.
Right. Yes, I saw that. I saw that as well. Very good. Okay.
For the valuation, so that's why we have a form.
So repeat that for us. Call back and inform us as to what has to be done when you have an objection. Good morning.
Lennox Tunapuna here again, brother. I want to tell people something. I don't know if people are watching news, but last night they had people from Tobago who had problems with the valuation thing and whatnot. And when they went into the office to query it, you know what they tell them? They have no way how to deal with this issue. Nothing was put in place. So people just go in there, you know, helter-skelter, and they're telling people, go there, you go do this, you go get redressed and whatever. It happened nothing like that because they interviewed people last night on television, and I think it's in Tobago, and they have nothing in place.
Exactly so what I suspected.
Anybody who listening could call and clear the air on it for me, please, brother. Okay?
Yeah. So anybody who would have had that experience that you objected, but there is no mechanism in reality, in all practicality, to accommodate objection. I would love to hear from you. Good morning.
Hello. Good morning, Lennox.
Good morning.
I just want to throw a reference to something apart from all the talk that's going on this morning. Between Shaguana flyover and Chase Village flyover, they are extending the lanes to a 3-lane, right, from Shaguana's, because it's causing a backup of traffic. Now, mind you, it's a short distance between Shaguana's and Chase Village, and there are two contractors doing that job. One is Junior Sammy, and the other is Siriram Brothers. For such a small contract, they give two contractors. Now, the thing is, I am an engineer by trade as well, and I've been paying close attention to what is going on there. And the fact is that Siriram Brothers have done a far superior job than what Junior Sammy is doing. And on the piece that Siriram Brothers have been doing, they have almost completed the work, only to pave the last layer of asphalt now, while Junior Sammy is way behind on that job. Right? Wow. And I'm watching the quality of the work, and I'm wondering, how come Junior Sammy does get all those big contracts to do shoddy work, while a company like Siriram Brothers, who are very versed in road paving and road rehabilitation work? So it speaks volume, eh? Because if anybody passed there right now, they would see what's going on there. And that work started last year, and it causes major traffic, both on mornings and evenings, to traverse the work. So it leaves you to wonder, how come Junior Sammy could get all those big contracts and do shoddy work, and every work, every road they have built have almost been destroyed already? And we know for a fact that Siriram Brothers is the contractor that does a far superior job. It speaks volume. Good morning, everybody.
Good, very good observation, and thank you, of course, for that information, because, of course, what comes to mind. All right, let's go straight to the lines, and then, of course, I'll give my intervention afterwards. Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Lennox Smith.
Good morning to you.
Right, personal non grata. What is happening? What is happening here? Did the UNC made any pronouncement with respect to the property tax? If they do in fact win the election, what they're going to do with the tax?
I thought by now that it's public knowledge, they would repeal.
Well, I'm
category.
Not
one statement, they will repeal.
Yes, but I'm not hearing that. You know, this is what I'm saying, I'm not hearing that. The fact remains, I do it, you know, but I'm not hearing it on the, nobody, in fact, you saying it now. But I haven't heard that among the callers, you know what I'm saying? So I'm saying the message is not getting out there. The other thing about, I think this gentleman said, this gentleman, what's his name again? Saddam Hussein. I heard him on I think, one of the press conference, where he said that, you know, yes, you can object, and but there's no, the legislation make provision for a tribunal. He wrote to the president asking as to whether that tribunal, because the law says that the president is responsible for establishing the tribunal. She said that the tribunal, she hasn't put anything in place. And he also said, I don't want nobody, they'd like to sue, that the Minister of Finance had said that the tribunal was in place. And in fact, the tribunal, there's no tribunal. So I'm saying that there seemed to be a conundrum there with respect to the people appealing or bringing the matter before the tribunal and that kind of thing, people seeking redress. So I'm saying that it's important for people to know. Yes, you go about making you going about the process, but it is head. The people need to know also that the alternative government, which is the likely to be the government, the UNC, they have said categorically that they are going to review the legislation with respect to property tax, and that should be. People should bear that in mind. That message should be sent through Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you.
Well, let me be categorical here that the statement is that they will repeal that particular act, and of course they will revert, as they attempted in 2015, to reinstitute land and building taxes. If you hear from Imbert now, he would speak as though property tax and land and building taxes is one and the same. No, is another hoax, another ruse to try to deceive. land and building taxes is what you were paying before, $60, wherever it is, and so on, annually, and you're done with that, as opposed, of course, to the very complex, but a very, what I can say, pocket-only tax that they have now introduced through, or been introduced through the property tax mechanism. We go to the lines. A pleasant good morning.
Good morning. Calling from South.
Good morning.
I'm not paying no South property tax. I calling on the people. Don't pay none. They working for we. And when Imbot start to pay, then I will pay. I'm not paying none. And call on the people. Don't let us send letter. They can't do you nothing. Don't pay no tax. And if you're not getting water, don't pay water rate because you're not getting water. They're telling you conserve water. We're getting none, so we conserving. But them with the swimming pool and all them big shots, yeah, Rowley and all of them, we have water to the leisure. We are none. So we're not paying no water rate and no property tax. Thank you.
Yeah, Boston Tea Party, boy, the prelude to the American Revolution. No taxation without representation. Good morning.
Good morning. I support the last caller 100%. We not pay no property tax. The first problem we had was that he engendered fear in our mind by telling us we'll be charged $5,000 for not pulling the form. And people got scared. So that is nearly like duress, you know. And now they're telling me about 10% interest. This property tax is a monthly thing you're paying that like a salary, you know. When some people pay property tax, them like they're paying a CPF worker now, you know. Every month, you know, this is not quarterly or yearly, you know. Thank you.
Yeah, you're quite right. It's draconian, it's harsh, and it is, you know, particularly being implemented by a man who said that his constituents, at a time when there was milk and honey in Trinidad and Tobago, 2008-09, he said that people cannot afford an additional $100. Now we're talking about, in too many instances, thousands of dollars. We continue to process. Good morning.
Actually, we would not be going to any callers.
Okay,
it's top of the hour. Again, we need to go pay those bills.
Newbie, thank you very much. Newbie, of course, when Newbie talks, you just have to listen. People, of course, we will continue with these discussions and more after the break. See you thereafter.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
Chang'an Ari Restaurant is open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. 67 Western Main Road, St. James, opposite Standards. Serving local breakfast items like sada, fry bake, roast bake, and pies. With all your favorite local fillings. Assorted lunches available from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Get pilau for $25 or get combination lunches from $25 to $40. They also have soup specials as well as crab and dumpling from 6 p.m. Have dinner on the pavement a la carte with burgers, fried nuggets, gyro, and just about anything you can think about. Call 382-9347 to place your order. Shiny and Ari, Main Road, St. James, open 7 days a week.
David Guy and Son Funeral Services, with locations in High Street, Saparia, Port of Spain, Cuba, San Fernando, and Point Fortin, David Guy and Son Funeral Services is the choice for you. Having to lose someone you love is already hard, so funeral services and arrangements should be made easy. And at David Guy and Son, that is what we guarantee. We guarantee our customers exclusive services at affordable prices. Our services include funeral pre-arrangement packages, casket customization, great customer service, the latest in body preparation technology, and the best fleet of vehicles to give your loved ones the send-off they deserve. With 5 convenient locations located nationwide, feel free to call or visit us today. With full packages starting from as low as $7,500, call David Guide and Son Funeral Services today. Distinctive, not expensive.
104.7 and Wired 868 every Thursday at 3:30 p.m. for your sports and review. Weekly sports update, live interviews, opening and closed credit. 1 by 30 seconds and 5 minutes. Join us and be in the know.
Or call 789-2881.
Round the clock, you can't stop, you're on the go. KFC have something for you. So delicious, it's our favorite meal. And KFC we deal. We deal is the real thing. Come get a whole meal on your time, eh? We deal.
you're on the go, you always have time for a delicious meal with the KFC Wee Deal. Enjoy two pieces of golden chicken and two regular sides for only $34.95 today. From KFC, it's finger-licking good.
Looking for top quality and affordable hardware supplies? Then look no further than Midland Hardware, number 97 Eastern Main Road, Arouca. We stock a wide range of tools, water tanks, blocks, lumber, steel, and everything you need for your home and business project. Check out our new display of steel windows and assorted designs of metal curtain rods. Midland also stockpiles sand, gravel, topsoil, and more. We have a variety of kitchen faucets, face basins, and toilet sets, bathroom mat sets, all garden tools, hand tools, generators, power washers, and water pumps. Customers can make payments via links, credit card, online payment, and cash on delivery. WhatsApp 327-7761 for free quotations, or give us a call at 646-2144. Open every day, Sunday to Sunday, from 8 a.m. From foundation to finish, it's all at Midland.
Every word. Every line. Every paragraph. Depicts a real moment in someone's life. A father, a sister, a mother, a brother. We at Newsday are dedicated to you, the people, and through independent, unwavering journalism, strive to always bring your stories to life. Because your stories are more than just words. Newsday, independent and credible.
Yes, indeed, of course. So we are back. We are back. Time clock is just about 14 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock. And of course, we continue to take your calls. And of course, very, very delightful as well as informative. And I want to say very informed callers. I think you've done yourself human service to the nation, true patriots. And these discussions very relevant and concerning bread and butter issues, but of course Trinidad and Tobago as a civilization, as a society, and of course knowing where the bugbearers are and trying of course to neutralize them so that we can have a smoother running Trinidad and Tobago with good governance, transparency, accountability, and the melting pot, in the melting pot that we all know Trinidad and Tobago to be, with the diversity and the complexities, not dissimilar to other societies, but unique in the sense of our ethnic compositions and our various religion, etc., etc. That being as it may, of course, let's go back to the lines. Pleasant good morning once again to all and sundry. Let me, of course, I cannot stop thanking that good Samaritan, that patriot, he likes to call himself, for without being without soliciting, offered, and of course I received it yesterday afternoon before the corridor transformation. I was able to, of course, collect a cell phone that I can now use to make certain that you can call me on the normal numbers. Not yet. I have to go and get it activated properly after the program. The numbers to call: 229-0251, 229-0251, 239-5120, 239-5120, and of course WhatsApp 366-3053. I don't know. I know you'll be around this time. We normally would focus on the
voice notes
on those WhatsApp calls. I don't, those were WhatsApp, you know, interventions.
That's not a problem. So just give me a few minutes.
You can do that before we go back to the lines, but don't forget, after the program, call Andy and you know, leave a little package for him.
Lennox, so
that would be a good motivation. Good morning.
Hi, Lennox. Morning. Hear this. Give me a few minutes and we'll go to the WhatsApp calls, right? And callers, please, when you are calling in, just reduce your volume. Thank you very much. We'll take the WhatsApp calls in a short bit.
All right. Okay then. All right. So, I didn't hear quite clearly, but do we? Are you saying we have someone in line?
Noah said that I will take phone calls shortly, and for callers to reduce their volumes. That's what I said.
Oh, I said. Okay, right, great. So go ahead. Taking some time. Are we doing WhatsApp calls now or not? All right.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning. I'm not certain if we are doing WhatsApp or call, so you'll forgive me my hesitancy. So,
right, okay, because I wasn't hearing you. So good morning.
All right, okay, go ahead, caller. Make your contribution.
Andy, where you are, blessings, and Mikey. Monday the 18th, Brian Lara, and head to the DPP. I want to talk about one issue, and then I'll talk about the SSA and the collapse of the SSA. Property tax. You know they're sending out these assessment valuation and they're telling you have 21 days, right?
Right.
You have to find out, and I would like to, somebody tell me, the 21 days is the day you get it in your mailbox or the date on the letter? Because we have a pressing issue. You know, the postal service is on strike. So you are getting that within 4 weeks. So you get in your assessment after the time for you to make a review of it.
21-day response. Yeah.
Right. You understand where I'm going with that? You have a date on the letter. You're getting it late,
right.
and you have no time to respond because the 21 days will have gone. Okay, let me go to my real substantial response. To the SSA and the spy and things like that. Mm. I want people to understand. I believe it have more to the mortar than the pestle. And I want to know if the whitelist, remember they say they have a whitelist for who not to surveil, and then they have a blacklist which is surveil.
Mm-hmm.
During the surveillance of people on the blacklist, because Gary the other day say he and his wife was being surveilled. Remember, it had a fiasco where independent PNN senator was WhatsApping judges. Are they surveilling judges? I am asking. I don't know. The other day a judge say he has been seeing threats. Are they surveilling all of those things, putting pressure on people? Were they surveilling the special branch officer and they intercept the surveillance and the communication with a spouse of the highest politician in office in Trinidad and Tobago? I'm just saying, I'm not saying I have facts or evidence, but the way this thing is falling apart, it tells me to believe that it's something, as I say, more than more than personal. You have a fellow that's called Fitzy. Every time he come out of a GSE meeting, he's always say, politicians communicating with criminal elements. You remember there was a certain incident where a set of money was taken from somewhere up in La Hawkett from an army man who had a Ponzi scheme and went to a police station and come back. Remember, there was a linkages with a high politician. Remember, the head of the National Security Council take over that investigation and that investigation gone dark. I think they charge a little corporal. No.
Yeah, drug susu.
You're better than me and my brains. Let me give you another data point. The lead officer of the security detail for the ICE man, somewhere down in Central, they shoot him and they say where the phone. What is a villain he? Was he aware of so many things if people went by Buddhist and things like that? He was not part of the cartel, so they had to get rid of him. You understand what I'm saying? I just throwing out questions. But I believe when the Kakada fall out and the wife found out that he's surveilling she, they're going for holidays abroad. I go and I ain't seen nothing again. Morning.
I hear you, my friend, of course. There are those who would dismiss it as conspiracy theories, but under this administration, anything is possible, and therefore that they will go to the extreme, very complex. We saw that, of course, with Vincent Nelson, and we saw that with Brent, with the Brent matter, where, of course, a plane was used from the region to, of course, bring him back, kidnap him, in one instance, a judge said. Let's go back to the lines. A pleasant good morning. Welcome. We continue, of course, to take your calls. And yes, very interesting indeed in terms of what is required. Yes, the law says that there should be this commission to look at ultimately. But so the application is one thing. The form is there. You send it to the respective how many offices? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, Baratari, of course, being the head office, where the evaluation people for property tax is located.
Yeah, good morning,
for families building. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning.
I hear you saying good that. Good morning. I hear you saying that people could complain about the property tax there somewhere to go.
According to the information I have, they can go at the head office in Barataria to deposit their company as well.
I don't think you should tell them nothing. You know why? People fill out blank form without name and address on it. Right? Pull it out and go and carry it all over the place where they're supposed to carry it. Leave them alone. Do you fill out a blank form? You post something in somebody's box, a blank form, without name and address, and all you pull it out? Will you tell them the government put anything there for? A fellow make an argument with me on this and that and the other. So I had to ask him, I say, if you get a blank check in your bank box, you will fill it out with the bank? They fill out blank form, leave them.
Very good analogy, because we were telling them don't to do it. But of course, the reality is that the government got a handshake, a easy way, of course, to now communicate with them, and they have taken advantage of it. However, there is a mechanism for objection, and I'm just putting it in the public domain, because that is what we are all about. So even if you made a mistake there, the objection is there, but you may have another reprieve, and that is, even if you put in your objections, there is no mechanism to ventilate it, to no tribunal to evaluate it and to make a decision. That is how this government operates. But they still want, of course, the property tax. Good morning. Good morning. Yeah, I'm just saying this is how not short-sighted or short-handed, but very deceptive, and they're very deliberate in terms of their, for want of a better term, criminalistic behavior and undermining, of course, the processes in this country to have their way. They simply cannot be trusted. That's the point. I'm saying all that just to say that they simply cannot be trusted. And of course, the Kamala Prasad has said that in government, the UNC will repeal that and revert back to the land and building taxes. So at least there are two reprieves. One, that there is nothing in place to actually ventilate, so that will stay in the system if you are minded to object. And then, of course, you have Kamala Prasad, which is inevitably coming into office maximum next year, when, of course, when your frustration and your anxiety and your trauma will be relieved. So all you have to say, have no fear, Kamala and the UNC would have been here. We continue to take your calls. The numbers to call, don't forget, for the new callers are 229-0251, 229-0251, 239-5120, 239-5120, and of course, WhatsApp, 366-3053. I don't know if Newbie will accommodate WhatsApp now. It's up to you. Just inform me and I will do what is required. That is to say, simply shut up. Newbie?
Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. Newport and its crew.
And any other one? Okay.
Good morning, Lennox, from Newport. Hold on, eh?
All right, so we are playing those mails now, voicemails.
Yeah, Lennox. I just want to say to Mr. Rowley, I think with this property tax, you really want people to go homeless and own no house, because you said if you don't have to pay property tax, if you're not paying property tax, then you don't have a home. So you know what that means, according to Ms. Kamala Pasabisessa. I see clearly now that this man wants everybody to go homeless if they don't pay the property tax. But woe be unto this man, right? And another thing is, with the Valsin big house there and this guy, I don't know why they have to, how they're looking for this man, where they have helicopters, they have drones, they have police army, and they can't find this man. And I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, is there any, was there children in the house to Lennox? I don't know, if I heard, it is alleged that they had children, the man had other children in the house. And I feel that if they raid the house, they should carry all those children in the police station and question one by one the whole thing, what was going on in that place, because this is not right. And so sad for that child, bones that they found in the back of the house. May her soul rest in peace now. It is so hard what this government then doing. They're not doing anything to solve the crime. They're not investigating anything. They all they're only saying they go investigate. 1 week, 2 week pass, 3 week pass, and they forget about it. It's too many children in this country suffering. Too many children in this country, in the homes, wherever. At home, where the parents can't put food on the table for them, little babies are crying, right? When they're crying, so the parents getting frustrated, might as well beat them and do them all kind of things we don't know about what happened behind closed door, right? People, you need to focus on the children. Children is being, and they're crying out just for somebody to help them, somebody to rescue them. What the police them doing? What they're doing? Eh? They need to go and search all these places, these big men in high places. What are they doing to these children? This is so sad. I'm not a mother, you know. I don't have no children. I'm minding dogs and cats, right? I have no children, but I am a woman. I could feel, right? Then it have some careless mothers out here. All they only starting to do is go out and you know, make do whatever they have to do and forget the children at home. I know what I'm telling you. I hear people talk. I hear people crying out. This is so sad what's going on in this country, and Rowley them not putting anything in place for these children. Look how many children in school fighting. Look how they're carrying on. We have soldiers sitting there where they can come out and work together with the police. Enforce more laws in the schools. We have an education minister that don't work, she don't work 50 cents. She only coming up and talking and set a baloney, and she not doing anything for the schools and to put things in place for the education and for the bullying and the fighting and all these things in school. If I was the prime minister, I didn't make a joke with that, you know, if I was the prime minister. I would have put laws, strict laws in place for school and education and for the children and for the elderly. Right? This is my cry this morning and I'll never see media on Monday, Lena. Okay.
Very passionate people.
Morning. Yep.
Good morning. I can't tell if we are on WhatsApp or not. So you don't have to
call. Is that call?
My dear.
Is that call?
All right, okay. Call out. Go ahead.
Good morning. Andy Williams, Mikey Key, and John Tobago. That's why we are the critical crossroads in the history of our country. And every day I wake up in this country, I wake up with a heaviness in my heart, not sure, not certain as to whether or not I will reach back home safe, whether or not my family will reach back home safe. This is where we are in this country. People are living in fear that they will not even make it through the day, not because they're sick, but because there's nothing in this country anymore that provides a measure of safety and security to citizens. It seems as everything has just gone down the drain. When will it stop? I saw the Dr. Munila call for security protection for the pastor. But even that and all, I am concerned about, because I don't know to what extent that the police service is corrupt. To what extent would he be safe? Because if we have the SSA operating at that level, we're supposed to have control and monitoring mechanisms in place to ensure that agency operate at the highest standard. And that and all they cannot do. What safety? How can we confident that the pastor will be safe? This SSA thing is very much, much cause for concern. Who is the government minister that is alleged to have underworld connection? Who it is? Who is the official? Who is the government official? Right? These are things that are very concerning to me, because we are hearing about the pastor going to Israel, which is allegation, because he alleged that he went to Israel with the head of the SSA to acquire intelligent retrieving device that is able to decode encrypted messages on WhatsApp. And we know in this country that the intent behind that should be, once somebody is suspected of being involved in criminal activities, that these people becomes a subject for the agency. But we know in this country, you and I, Lennox, could be under monitoring. They could be tapping our phones, listening to our conversation, just because you and I have a different perspective in terms of attacking the government for their malpractice, for their neglect, for their failures. So they could be listening to our conversations too. So therefore, we would not have the equal opportunity or rights to access anything that an ordinary citizen who's supporting the government and so forth would be able to. Our children might have applications in NHDC, and they get denied application for job in government agencies, and they get denied. Why? Because they are tapping into our infrastructure. This place, Lennox, has gone staring mad under this government. And until we in this country open our eyes as citizens who want to put this country first and put aside our political affiliations and put an end to what we are seeing here, because there's no longer a creeping dictatorship. You know, this is full-blown dictatorship. You understand? People are refusing to answer questions. At one point in time, the Prime Minister Lennox had said that the intelligence received from the special branch is not evidence, so he couldn't act on it. But in this instance, you get information, right? This is not evidence neither, but you act on information. And then you want the public to believe that the lie that you tell us, one, the first instance, you get information from the police. And then when questioned in parliament, no, you didn't get information from the police. Lennox, this thing is concerning to me because our country is under risk. Everything is being compromised. Everything is being corrupted. And as far as I am concerned, enough is enough. We have to put an end to this. And I'm calling to Trinidadians, stand up for your country and let's put an end to this by ensuring that this government comes out of office now. Have a good day. March 18, we're coming out.
Yes, indeed. Of course, don't get mad to the extent to which this admission is mad, because clearly they have proven to be, of course, a total collapse, a total incompetent.
Come on, callers, I'm talking on behalf of Mighty K and especially Andy. Make all your voice not short now. When all you make it long, long, so you don't have no chance for other people to get in for them on the play. Let us be real now. Please make it short.
Grand Venice, evil bad. Judgment. Well, that's my voice. So did not play yesterday.
Good morning, Ground Report. Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. I will not be surprised to hear that Rowley and the PNM accuses Kamla and the UNC for being behind or engineering the SSA latest fiasco. Nothing to doubt the way this man does lie.
Kingsley, don't feel you're so important in the UNC. You remember the embarrassment where they throw you out for roti, they refuse the roti and then call the police to put you out. So don't fool yourself and feel that you're so important.
King Lee, take it from me, you are a buffoon. Take it from Orlando, you are a buffoon. I will send you a book to you. About Donald from the mafia. This man is a mafia. America is getting confused about Donald Trump. He hypnotizing like Rowley, hypnotizing the country with Obia. I don't know what Donald Trump has. The man is a buffoon. 22 of his business collapse, dry up like a tree like you. You are a buffoon. The man has no idea what he's doing. Everything he touches turns to dirt. That's Donald Trump. So buffoon Kingsley, keep your mouth quiet about Donald Trump. You don't have no idea. You have never read nothing about the man. So keep quiet, all right, Mr. Buffoon Kingsley?
Good morning, Mikey, Lennox, Andy, Newbie, and to everybody out there. Well, I had a good laugh when somebody told me that Dr. Rowley, when he was stealing the sod for some houses in Lavendale or whatever, he said he's going to put a golf course. To do what? He should put a shooting range. Why does Dr. Rowley keep fooling the people and the people keep falling for it? Oh, come on, man. This is 2024. You all have a lot of sense. He took away the laptop from the children and he opened a library. He was the one that said that people don't read again. It's so easy to Google something or whatever information and to go and sit in the library and have, I don't know how much they paid the children or whatever, the parents, to come and say that they praise up the library in Diego Martin. What is wrong with these people? I don't know when it is people are going to take off their blinkers or blinders, whatever you want to call it. When are they going to take it off and realize that PNM is not good for this country? They continue to fool the people, fool the people, fool the people. Now they are spending $148 million to build a building for social welfare. Look at how many buildings we have in and around Port of Spain that they could have refurbished or might have cost them more. But why is it necessary now in these hard times to build that building? For what? To show off? Like the new one they built for the Ministry of Health? Just to show off and all the suffering the people? Couldn't that money have been given to the pensioners, increase the disability grants, the children with cerebral palsy? Couldn't that money have been spent better elsewhere? But no, you know what, we like it so. Because every Monday morning and twice on a Sunday is Kamala this and Kamala that and Kamala the next one. And speaking of that, can somebody please send Robin Montano clippings of the Monday night meetings and so on, so that when he go to a meeting, when he go to an interview, he wouldn't be sounding, I want to use the right word, challenge. He wouldn't be sounding challenge. That what is Kamala doing for us? Yes, she said what she doing for the country, but what is she doing for us? What the hell is she doing for you? How many times she talk about the property tax already and what they will do? Yes, we heard her say she will abandon the property act. But what is she doing for us? Oh, jeezy beezies. Come on, man. I don't know what is wrong with these people, you know. I think he had another spur.
Wrong report. Good morning. Come on, Andy. Be back in here. We're supporting you. Get well fast. We need you back on this program. Okay, hear what? Keith already tell us if we don't take the vaccine, we don't have a job. Think about it. Now you come and tell us if you don't pay property tax, they don't have a home. They will end up in the house or the building along by Asia River, by the bridge. If you don't pay property tax, you end up in that home. So which means what you're into there? You're paying tax, you lose your house? Just question for the nation. Think about it.
Yes, of course, it appears that we have exhausted, of course, those voicemails. So we go back to the lines. And of course, Rowley doesn't fail to amaze. As to the level of his pernicious, devilish, and evil concoctions, like it's as if he has a bottomless pit of these evil, having regard to the fact that he has depended on the people to be where he is. And then, of course, if there is any kind of betrayal, well, that is the classic case of betrayal, perfidious indeed. Let's go back to the lines, 229-0251. 229-0251. Mike, are you there?
Yeah, just cutting in here. Pleasant good morning to you, my brother Lennox Smith, a newbie, brother Andy Pitbull Williams. I was just in discussions there, of course, with the chairman for the entire morning, Robert Amar, of the pushback.
Yes.
Right. So he is definitely going to enlighten you on his program up next on Sense and Sensibility. He's going to tell you, of course, everything. So the chairman, and it's his role. So he was going to fill in all the blanks for you coming up next at 9 a.m. right here on More 104.7 FM. So a lot is taking place. Yes. We can squeeze in some calls from the people. And in his words, he said, listen, Mikey, if there's an issue with the people coming to us, then we will go to the people. And I mean, well thought out, well strategized, and definitely engineered by the commitment and dedication that we have shown throughout the year. So folks, it's always about for the people, by the people, and most importantly, with the people. Who's on the outside? Morning, welcome.
And I've always said that more potent ways of
dealing
with matters when we are closed.
We have a call on. Go ahead, caller. Morning.
Yes, morning to the ground court. And you guys. March 18th, Rowley, we don't pray, dear boy. Now, I'm a little human for you. Let me make it quick, right? According to Sprang, Johnny Depp and them is joking and them and all about pirates.
Look on the background, yeah. So we can hear you clear.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah, according to Sprang, right? According to Sprang, he said Johnny Depp and them is joking. Them don't know what is Pirates of the Caribbean. And they said, come down and meet Rowley and the PNM government. And then they're going to know it's Pirates of the Caribbean. Morning.
Thank you.
Mikey, before your next caller, let me pay some bills now.
Yeah, quickly. Let's pay some bills quickly and come right back. We are energized and ready to go, folks. Again, I apologize for the late entry, but the chairman, Robert Amar, will fill in the blanks for you when he gets in on Sense and Sensibility. So please stay locked on. Let's pay some bills. We'll be right back.
The Ground Report with Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
What goes in is a local something that makes it all, taste better. It's the flavor of our culture. Come from here, come from there, and everywhere.
It's the special flavor that's bitter silver at the Royal Castle.
Welcome the Royal Castle.
Royal Castle.
Flavor to the bone.
Royal Castle.
Taste the very own.
Royal Castle is the local something that makes it all taste better.
Taste the unique flavor of our culture at Royal Castle.
Hey, More FM has more ways to enjoy the best music ever made. Connect with us on our social media handles. IG, Iconic 1047 underscore FM. Facebook, Iconic 1047. TikTok, Iconic 1047 FM. And don't forget to follow our website, www.iconic1047.com. Like the pages, photos, videos, and our live stream with the team's hard at work and play. Catch up with everything. More FM. Follow our website. Don't forget, get More FM app on your Android or iOS. Download
every
it
word.
Today.
Every line. Every paragraph. Depicts a real moment in someone's life. A father, a sister, a mother, a brother. We at Newsday are dedicated to you, the people, and through independent, unwavering journalism, strive to always bring your stories to life. Because your stories are more than just words. Newsday. Independent and credible.
Hey, you! Yes, you! Need quality printing at affordable prices? Then look no further. At Graphic Source, we've got you covered. Take your project to the next level for all your designs and printing needs. From t-shirt printing to labels, signs, and banners. Look no further. Business stamps, flyers, tickets, and invites, just to name a few. With two convenient locations. Eastern Main Road, St. Augustine, opposite Massey Stores. And Arima Shopping Center, Broadway Street, Arima. Contact us today. 342-2664-270-0428 or 360-8917. Graphic Source, your number one source. You name it, we design it and print it.
Get ready to board the Harbor Master. Sunday night for Howie T annual boat cruise, Clash of Generations. Sunday, 31st March.
Bring your badness and come. I want you to bring your badness and come. Come again.
Boarding 11 p.m. Sailing 12 midnight. Dress elegantly in orange and black. Featuring Angel Journey, Digital Dice, King Kabuki, and the Hitman Howie T.
Howie T.
Welcome to King of the Dancehall.
Tickets at $200. Get them now at Sion's Bar San Fernando, Como Barbershop, Busy Corner Mall, Chagones, Bobby's Bar, Q-Rap, Caliente Bar, Q-Rap, Fans International, Trin City Mall, and Arima. New Luna Bar, Aruka, Revive Beauty Bar, McCoy Lights, Ben's Hideaway, Pinto Road, Arima, Roadside Cafe San Juan, Amanda's Grill, Excellent City, Forest Bay, and the Sour Sour Team, the Hitman, Howie T, annual boat cruise, Clash of Generations.
Me and the band is DJ from down the 90s.
I love the vibes where you bring.
Sunday, 31st March, get ready to board the Harbor Master. Easter Sunday night, 104.7 FM is the official station for Clash of Generations.
A lucky homeowner will win a brand new car.
Yes!
a brand new Mitsubishi Expander Cross. Yes, park in your four-vehicle parking space. Limited availability. Get in a gear with DG Home's newest gated community, Daniel Estate, the oasis of Canupia, will satisfy your needs for a new lifestyle. Beautifully designed, three bedrooms, two baths, modern interior, sophisticated finishings, with superbly manicured landscaped green spaces, front and a backyard included, starting at $1.65 million. Call now and book a viewing. 691-5659. Beautiful home, beautiful car, beautiful life. Home is DG Homes, Daniel Estate, Canupia.
Guys, we are back. Well, it seems as though I'm by myself, and I might have to go straight to the radio. I mean, straight to the callers, right? So the lines are open, everyone.
Yes. We are back. The lines are open. Go ahead quickly. Yes, we hear you. Go ahead.
Grong Report. Good morning, Grong Reporters. Pleasant Arriba. Let me talk on the mismanagement of the country again for a moment. When the Prime Minister and his cabinet stands in Parliament or in public spaces to talk, they always refer, compare Trinidad and Tobago to other parts of the world. When it comes to water supply, they can't. Dubai is in the middle of the desert. Dubai has water 48 hours in a day, water spewing all over the place, and it's done in a systematic way where people enjoy it. We live in, we just are dirt amongst water, and for days now, there is no pipe-borne water in most of the country, but they want to talk, they want to compare us to what? They compare us to the high crime rate in parts of the developed world, in the first world nations. We are not first world, and under this government, we will never be first world. Have a good day.
Thank you, caller. What up there, newbie? We have any calls? All right. What I found interesting here was that Minister of Social Development, Donna Cox, is taking the Valsin South community to task for failing to report suspected abuse at a house where the bones of an 18-year-old were found on Tuesday in a shallow grave. You know, some residents, of course, claim they contacted police and the Children's Authority over the years after they noticed suspicious and concerning behavior at the house, but did not receive favorable responses from the two state authorities. Now, despite these claims, Minister Cox said she was deeply concerned about the conditions the family had been living in before and after the tragedy occurred. She said as the investigation into the startling discovery continues, the minister expressed her disappointment. She's disappointed in the neighbors who may have turned a blind eye to the suspected plight of Hannah and other children at the house. My goodness, Donna. My goodness, you have no shame. You and the entire cabinet have no shame. You serious woman? You disappointed in people? You disappointed because you believe that they turn a blind eye? Donna, where were your eyes when it came to Emailgate? Donna, where were your eyes when it came to Petrotrin? Donna, where were your eyes when it came to the SSA? Where were your eyes when you was holding these press conferences in the heights of the COVID pandemic? Where were your eyes when money was mismanaged? Where were your eyes when people were dying on wards because they didn't have the resources? Where were your eyes, Donna? Where? You disappointed? You in the cabinet, and look how many things you turn a blind eye to. Could you shed some light on any of the NDAs that were signed by the Chinese? Could you shed some light with those very same eyes, the things that we may have lost as a country? Can you use those eyes for that, Donna? Take those spiders off your eyelids and tell us, because apparently you expect people to see clearly, but you're not seeing clearly at all. What are you blinded by, Donna? What it is that you throwing a blind eye on? Can you enlighten us, sister? Who is this minister that is embroiled in these allegations with SSA? Can you throw an eye there? Can you throw an eye on the 2,000 plus students that your boss said, the prime minister, that fell through the cracks? Can you put an eye on that? Again, take those spiders off your eyelids, Donna. Because here it is, you know everything about who turned a blind eye in Valsin. But have you been showing an eye on anything concerning this government from day one? Man, go from here with that, now, man. You're not going to go home, but ride out. Go somewhere, now, man. We are fooling with this nonsense. Like, always only talk conveniently. What? And that's why you have to come out of your comfort zone. You have to be ready. Because this is the nonsense they will throw at you at a daily basis. And you have to pick sense from nonsense. Don't know what happened to your eyes for the past almost 9 years. Hey, let's see if we can squeeze in a call quickly before we make way for Robert Amar and Sense.
Good morning.
Morning.
It's Krishna here. Monday the 18th, we're coming out of my decay.
Krishna, of all people that close the show, Krishna, not today. Now, man. I want real people, man. From the time I hear your voice, games just come on my head. It's Snakes and Ladders, it's Atari. Not this morning, please. Not this morning, man. You always come in, but you don't come like you in porn. Come on, man. Look, let me go now. Let me make way for Robert Amar. I fed up with this nonsense. Robert Amar is up next with Sense and Sensibility. We are out of here, folks. I don't have time for games. I'm sick and tired. You have people coming online to us as ministers, and we just supposed to sit down there and not question them. Newbie, cut that. Folks, until tomorrow, we are out of here. Don't forget later on tonight, we have Lennox Smith, Corridor Transformation at 8 o'clock on social media. Lot to discuss. Again, Mr. Amar, the chairman of the Pushback Movement, is up next. Stay locked on. On behalf of myself, Newbie, Andy Lennox, be safe until tomorrow. We're out of here.
With Mikey K, Andy Williams, and Lennox Smith.
6 a.m. to 9 a.m. Join Andy Williams, Michael Kerr, and Lennox Smith, the Ground Report team on M1047, as they rip apart the lies, half-truth, and misinformation that the mainstream media never discuss. The Ground Report. Hard-hitting, informative, undiluted, uncompromising, and unfiltered. Monday to Friday on M104.7 FM. Get the raw facts before making any life-changing decisions. Only on The Ground Report.
Disclaimer. More FM Limited, its owners and associates, accepts no responsibility for statements made by the talk show hosts or their guests. More FM Limited does not endorse any of the information provided during this commercially booked segment as the truth. That you have to judge for yourself. We, however, reserve the right to question statements made. But in this time of misinformation, government-controlled media, and corruption, it is sometimes hard to get the truth. But we must try. It is not our intention to discriminate or annoy anyone. We believe it is our constitutional right to free speech, to voice our opinion, and our duty to the population and country to expose the truth. More FM Limited takes no responsibility for the opinions of others.
This is More FM 104.7. Iconic radio. Load it.
Lock it.
Leave it.
Love it.
Live it.
And learn it.
More FM 104.7.
More FM 104.7. On the move. On the move. Everywhere.
Fall in love with radio.
All over again.
All over again.
More FM
104.7. Gotta pay some bills. More FM will be right back.